Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, children of all ages, Fat Entitled Bastards proudly presents the return of our actual engineer, Caitlin!
Woo! Three cheers for Caitlin!
It turns out we were recording the whole show off of our fucking laptop microphone last time.
So you spent like X amount of money on this really nice...
I swear to God, it sounded like it got better.
Yeah, we didn't do shit.
I'm glad to be back. I'm glad to be back.
Well, we were having a whole discussion on the show about how it was dumb that you went off to do like life things and adult stuff.
You were adulting.
Just doing fucking school stuff.
I need a
which
career.
It's cool.
I want a future.
Which... No. So this is the thing. I really like making apps and websites. I'll do a quick plug here too. If you guys know anyone who needs or wants that, I'll start with us
you
with
take your
fat
filthy
title
shameless
bastards.
That's fine. If you're gonna give something away, that's fine.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, yeah. Like I'm just gonna make a website for us, I guess, because that's like the next logical step.
But... your filthy shameless plug.
Yeah,
no.
I'm sorry.
So shameless.
I'm sorry. Just,
shout out
you know.
Your website.
I'm not looking for a job.
Oh yeah, yeah. No, I mean it's just you know. Well, I won't do that because I don't know.
You don't want your professional life.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, or like I don't even know if we know my full name on this show. I don't know if it's made
Caitlin
known.
Caitlin Special K?
Yeah, Special K.
Special K. Quintuple Double.
Quintuple Double. What's
and
that?
Mad Matt. That's my name.
Yeah,
you know,
no, I know.
They call me Alpha Matt at work now.
Yeah, they do.
Are you serious? Oh my God.
It's on my key.
That's like...
As a matter of fact, when they called Matt when I went in there, she goes, need Matt T. And I guess somebody asked, which Matt? And they were like, she goes, Alpha Matt.
Matt's dick gets hard
Matt.
A little bit every time someone says
like,
that.
Like, I was trying to look Alpha professional Matt. Sitting there, but I was sitting there, I was like, that shit's so funny.
Oh, my God.
It's so funny.
Here's what's
funny.
Really funny is that there's other Matts that work there.
Yes. Yes.
So they're like, how does the other Matt feel about you being called Alpha Matt? And like, you want to know what the truth is? He's like, what? I don't fucking care. He's like, so alpha. it actually started out as a fat joke that I made that nobody really got, right? So, like, there was two Matts there, and I was bigger than both of them. Mm-hmm. So I just said, since I'm the biggest in the natural world, I must be the alpha, right? So it was
absolutely.
A veiled fat joke that just caught on in a completely different light.
Which is, I feel like that's such a you thing to do. You're like, let me take something that could otherwise be like, oh, like... Like, first of all, I'm going to beat someone to the punch of a joke, but then I'm also going to make me look really good.
So I didn't do anything cool about it. I just made it so ridiculous, and everybody laughed and told me it was never going to happen, and now 90%
and
of
now,
the store calls
like,
me out.
And now it's happened.
It's written on my keys.
That's how Mad Matt works, though. I mean, that's...
So, but that's the beauty of the whole thing. Also, coincidentally, if the audio on the show sounds significantly better than the drop that will be like 3 days before this episode, it might be because our engineer actually turned on the audio input for the microphone.
Absolutely.
So that's like a thing.
You know what's really weird is trying to actually like rig... No. I'm just saying like it's not nearly as intuitive and I don't know. Hopefully, maybe even on the next show we will have... even better audio.
The next show? We don't have funding for that.
Wait, you're right. No, you're right. You're right. I'm sorry. I spoke too soon.
But, so right now I'm actually making them watch Lucha Underground on mute.
Dude, it's super cool.
I actually think I like it more than I like the other wrestling shows.
I'm not gonna lie. Like, the in-between stuff, like the storytelling, like, that shit's cool as hell.
I'll
make it seem like a movie.
Like, I haven't been really watching WWE at all, because... you know, crap. And TNA is essentially the scourge of all television. But this show, as terrible as it is actually pretty entertaining.
So, what I really like is the showmanship. And we had talked about this a little bit, but I like the level to which these, like, wrestlers commit to their, like, characters and, like, even their, like... You know, I mean, I don't know... Like, I guess their personas. You know, like, they have these, like... These characters, I don't know, I don't want to make it sound like fake and like, it's not real,
it is
but,
fake, but...
Well, yeah, but it's like very, I mean, it's like really intense improv is what it sounds like. It's like super crazy intense improv, and like, I don't know if the lines are scripted, but like, they deliver them infinitely better than like
you just
WWE, like...
professional wrestling.
Yeah, like...
Yeah, you really
like crazy, crazy improv.
So here's some fun facts, as we, before we turn
Holy
on the show,
shit.
Yeah, that's, I think, Layla, something like that. Attila, I think.
Taya. That's her name. Taya. That's
right. She's fighting a sexy star.
What was it? The sexy.
It's sexy star. Oh
yeah.
It's,
oh yeah. My god. That's right. Okay. Yeah. No. It's actually like it's
and
pretty
she wrestles
crazy.
Dudes all the time. In fact, they're wrestling for a title called the Gift of the Gods, where every season they give out 13 or it's like 7 to 13 pendants. I don't know the exact number, to be honest. But then they have to wrestle down to get a tournament championship. Ooh. And the winner gets a belt called the Gift of the Gods, and you can wrestle for, like, the title or whatever. And Sexy Star is the one who won it last year. There's only, like, 4 females in this whole show.
Yeah, dude. So they have to wrestle dudes?
They wrestle dudes all the time.
That's pretty fucking cool.
It's actually pretty baller.
Like, and it's cool, too, because, like, obviously, I think athleticism is a factor in any of, like, the televised wrestling events, but it's like, these women are, like, kicking each other in the face, and like one just jumped on the other with, like, I don't know. It's like really cool. Like,
so I have a thing. There's like a thing with wrestling. I believe in the showmanship of the show, right? So like, as you're doing dangerous moves, right? But they're supposed to look dangerous, not be dangerous. And so they do a very good job of making these moves that look really dangerous that are, you know, pretty safe. And that's something that's been happening in the WWE, is where these guys wrestle all these house shows all the time. They have all these injuries and stuff. And in this, what ends up happening is they only wrestle like 16 times a year.
Dude, that's awesome. Like, especially because even like the pre-show leading up to the actual match was, it was pretty like interesting and kind of wild. And like a dude got his leg broken in a car door. Like,
yeah, that was
like,
cool.
You know, I mean, like, I just feel like there's a level of commitment here that you're like, wow. You know, I mean, like, obviously he didn't have his leg broken.
They also do a good job of picking up the guys that like get dropped by WWE, right? So right now in the ring is the Johnny Mundo, right? And he used to be Johnny Nitro. And then you also have the Darewolf. He used to be this dude, Gabriel something, in WWE. They're both like high flyer dudes, and they tagged him up as a trios tag team. So a trios team is 2 dudes and a chick, or 3 dudes, or 3 chicks, or it's just a triple.
Yeah, like 3, yeah.
So like, there's another team jumping in where they're all in like luchador masks and shit like that. Like, that's the whole thing about this show, is that it's like, that's Phoenix, and there's a whole bunch of other dudes in the show like that are like world class wrestlers, but they come from like AAA in Mexico and stuff like that. So some of the guys don't even speak English. But my favorite guy is a guy named Pentagon Jr., and he has 0 fair. That's him right there. You just missed it.
Wait, they're all wearing, like, the skeleton gloves? Wait, is that, like, all his fans? Zero fair.
I'm going to show you a picture of Pentagon Jr. And he's, like, the guy who's trained by Vampiro. Who's like the low rate Sting?
Oh yeah. Who's this like big bald motherfucker who I don't think said a word during any kind of commentary? Like, obviously we're not listening to it now, but before we had it, you know, just like regular volume, what the fuck ever. And I feel like he was just like very kind of quiet, big bald mother. Let me see.
Pentagon Jr.
Yeah. Okay.
And now he's Pentagon Dark. Which is his transformation to becoming a psychopath, right?
He's not even at his final evolution. Right. This isn't even his final form. Oh, God.
He's kind of spooky,
dude,
right?
He's creepy as fuck. Yeah. If you pull up...
And
okay,
he
what,
has
what's
zero
his
fear is the
Pentagon,
thing.
Pentagon Dark?
Yeah.
So, you guys should look this up because, oh, God, this man is really intimidating.
This demon.
So his finishing move is he breaks your arm.
What?
He gets on your Savage. Back, like you're on all fours, and he gets behind you and he grabs an arm and he jumps backward in the arm bar and breaks your arm. That's his gimmick.
Ooh.
And he has zero fear because he just takes a fight against anybody and any kind of match.
Zero fear.
He's like my favorite dude in this whole thing because he's a total lunatic. So that being said, Finn Balor was just nominated or just won the Universal Championship, which is supposed to be like Raw's championship.
Yeah.
But Seth Rollins in the match threw him up against the guard and he blocked it wrong, like he landed wrong, and he actually separated his shoulder in the match and reattached it, and then finished the match, won the title, and had to get rid of it the next day.
Yeah, he did.
Oh,
because he's gonna be out for 6 months with surgery. So they did this match where they had another match where they thought they were gonna give it to like Seth Rollins or like Roman Reigns or somebody, and they actually gave it to Kevin Owens. So like now, yeah. So now they're doing this thing where they're putting up all these guys who weren't title guys before to like reinvigorate the whole thing. So like it's starting to get more interesting with the brand split. But like there's some good matches going on. It's just the storyline is so doo doo. So what I like to do is I like to wait until it comes out on.
Well, so it almost sounds like what you at least just described. So dude like separates his shoulder and then he reattaches it in the middle of an event, right?
Like at, like, he's sitting there and you watch him pop his shoulder back into place.
Yeah.
Like, it's grody. It's so, like, I'll show you the YouTube video.
So it's like,
video
like these no, athletes and these performers.
I watched it on the WWE Network.
That's like, I mean, that's like tremendous, like, I don't know, athleticism, like grit and whatever. But like the storylines.
Athletic about popping your shoulder back.
Bro, I mean, that's just baller.
It's rough.
That's just
yeah,
baller.
I don't know. I guess in my mind, it's like your body has the ability to just like, all right, like I'm gonna make this happen. It's gonna hurt like a bitch.
That's
like
the adrenaline in you.
Yeah,
like,
yeah, yeah.
You're not even
but,
thinking about
so
it.
So it's one of those things where I feel like the storylines. Maybe in
that's Jean-Claude Van Damme. That's who you're looking at.
Yeah, yeah. maybe the storylines in
the
RZA
from the
Wu-Tang
Clan.
Just, yeah, I know. I was just saying. So this network is amazing.
The RZA.
First of all, the RZA, Ghostface Killer, Wu-Tang.
Like this, but like this whole collection of celebrities just appear. Anyway. No, I just feel like the storylines, like, maybe they're the same, but they're, like, better executed off-screen for Lucha Underground.
Yeah, that guy's a lunatic. You're just looking at him and be like,
he looks
I gotta
real
get
cry.
Off the phone. Sir, what can I do for you today? Where are the children? No, sir, we can't have this conversation.
No, okay.
Oh, God.
So, speaking of that, so there's these creepy clowns in, like, South Carolina.
Oh, my God.
They were in Greensboro.
That's, like, a really good transition.
They migrated up here.
Just got spotted in Greensboro.
Yeah.
It's not a good transition when you call it out.
Well, no. I do remember that from, like, the first show, but I just had to address well played.
I'm very good at that.
So, but these clowns, these creepy-ass clowns.
Luring people, including children, into the woods.
I think most especially children.
Most especially children.
Ugh.
So I have a first of all, I want to hear what you guys have to say about that, and then I'll chime in with why I think that it's just whatever.
It's so okay. I remember when I first read an article about this. I was hanging out with my friends Riley and Damien. And Damien was like,
as we call them, the DC movie bashing squad.
Yeah, that's true. They're just really dedicated DC fans. But so Damien was like, you know, this is when it was only happening in South Carolina. And he was like, dude, like one of those old boys in South Carolina is going to blow these clowns to bits.
Yes.
And so.
Yeah, they haven't. In the area where there's a lot of guns.
Yeah, no, I know. And so apparently the dude in Greensboro, though, like chased him with like a machete. I don't know. It's just funny because
like
it's
you
like.
Do.
Yeah, exactly. Like you do when you see a fucking clown. At the edge of the woods.
I'm a fucking Night of the Killer Clowns fucking clown in the fucking
Here's
woods.
My thing, though. If you can get lured into the woods by a creepy clown, this is just Darwinism at its finest. Like, this is the survival of the fittest.
But, I mean, like, do you know where they got that shit from, though? Right? Because you know, in general, there's these little pranks that they pull, and they're like overseas, like with the Chucky, and then they had the clown
chasing him around,
yeah,
with, like Jason
exactly,
costume or whatever,
yeah, that kind of thing. Like, this is where they're getting that shit from, but I'm just going to let y'all know, if I see one, they're going to get a hot one. That's all I'm saying. They're going to get a hot one.
This is a very pro-gun area,
oh,
so obviously.
A hot one.
So this is what's interesting to me, too. Sorry, I just thought of this. Riley, in fact, mentioned, she was like, what if this is just advertising for the new It movie?
Oh, yeah.
And I was like,
oh,
that's, you know, I hadn't considered that.
I have a hard time following any It movie that isn't with Tim Curry,
yeah.
You know?
Right, though? I mean, he is that clown. He is It.
That clown's going to need to be especially scary for me to be like, I don't have any idea who the fuck that is. But yeah, I'm going to need to see a really convincing clown to be It in those movies, the remake. Plus, that movie's like 3.5 hours long.
It's brutal.
I mean,
who's
really though,
the new guy?
If you're,
yeah.
I don't know,
oh,
look
sorry,
it up.
No. Yeah.
I got a cough.
Oh, lordy.
Oh, that's just my insides falling out.
Oh, my God. The sad thing is I don't know when he's joking anymore about that. But okay. So, what were you going to say?
My health is suspect. I live on the edge.
Mad Matt, we cherish you.
Oh, it's Rey Mysterio.
Rey Mysterio Jr. He's like 80.
Hashtag Lucha Underground. How old
hashtag,
is he, actually?
Hashtag he's streamer like, on the back of my head.
Mm-hmm.
Look at all those new tattoos he's got, too.
Mm. Yeah, that looks like pretty, like, rarely. Oh, okay, I see. Okay, so, actually, Alexander Skarsgård, his little brother, is going to be the new it.
There's like 70 Skarsgårds. They keep popping up. Yeah. So if you think about it, you got Alexander Skarsgård, who's like Eric Northman. Then you got this brother playing it.
Who was in that movie, Hemlock Grove, or that TV show, Hemlock Grove. That
horrible TV show,
Hemlock Grove. I tried to watch it. It was just not good.
It's really unwatchable.
Yeah.
Was he the werewolf in that?
Yes.
I think so. It's
this kid. I don't even, I blocked it out of my memory because I watched it 2 years ago and I was
Yeah, have you ever seen the show Vikings?
Yes.
You know Floki? Mm-hmm. That's also a Skarsgård.
Really?
Yeah, are that's they like related? Their older brother. What's up? Let me look. And their dad is the dude from fucking Avengers.
Oh, yeah, yeah. And Thor. Oh, God, what's, Stellan. God, Stellan, I love Stellan Skarsgård, though, like, just as an actor. He was in that crappy
Exorcist movie, but he made it, like, decent to watch.
Who is he?
Which, by the way, there's two of those movies, by the way.
I'll show you a picture.
Was he the king?
Who, what? What? When?
What?
You're talking about the Skarsgård's dad, and he was...
No.
Oh, okay,
that's their dad.
Oh, that's their dad?
That's their dad.
He's the scientist.
He's the sire. The man who sired all of the Skarsgårds. He's wonderful.
So, like, first of all, Alexander Skarsgård was actually a Marine. And, yeah, he was...
Oh, in Sweden, though. So
He was a United States Marine.
He was a United States Marine? I mean, dude's like 6 foot six or some shit, though. I mean, he's like, he's a big dude,
he's
so...
He's a very attractive man,
like,
too.
Yeah. He's a good-looking guy.
The worst part of his career, though, is when he went full nude for the end of True Blood. Yes. Everybody found out he had a tiny doink.
It was outside, so I'm told.
I feel like you would have probably done some presentation for that movie.
God, that's sad.
But, one of the things that he was in is like the Exorcist prequel, the one that the Exorcist at the beginning. There's actually two of those movies, and there's two versions of the same movie. And so the studio put out one, and they put out another one to like kind of counter that movie. So there's actually two prequels of the same name for that movie.
Oh.
It's like one of those like Stellan Skarsgård facts. One of the cool things about like that whole family is that they keep getting and shit like all the time. You could never know when there's so many Skarsgårds. They're like the Hemsworths. There's like three
except,
of them.
Except the Skarsgårds could take on the Hemsworths any day.
I don't know, man.
Or like the Osbournes.
You just said dude was a Marine for the United States Marine Corps.
Yeah, but one of them's Thor. So
right. Only one of them. The other one's like poor Liam Hemsworth
fucking Hunger Games.
Yeah, yes. Exactly.
He's tall. He's not small. He's just small as in his manliness.
No, exactly. Well, he's smaller than his brother.
He's actually taller than him.
No, he's not. Is he?
Yeah, he is.
Mm-hmm. Wait, so you mean to tell me, what's Gale from the Hunger Games is taller than Thor?
By like an inch or two, yeah.
They're brothers?
Look at it. Oh my god, Quincy, this is the whole thing. This is the whole conversation.
No, they look nothing alike!
Quincy, oh my god.
Quincy, all white people look alike, don't you know that?
No, fuck that.
Good God, Quincy, they're brothers. Obviously. God, they even their faces are similar.
Are you serious right now?
Yes, we're serious.
Quincy.
No, absolutely.
That's the dialogue for Quincy. Like
oh my God.
Gale from the Hunger Games and Alexander Skarsgård. No.
Thor, you ding dong.
Thor.
Oh.
Thor and
what's wrong with you?
I'm sorry. Quincy, you must be stopped. So so I just verified.
Like, the brain is a terrible thing. Quincy must be killed
like before somebody is seriously killed.
Quincy.
You must be stopped.
So this is super.
Your logic will blot out the sun.
Then they'll fight in that shade. So Gustav Skarsgård, I would say he's less like attractive than.
Yeah, but he's way more badass. Have you ever seen that show? Have you ever seen Vikings?
First of all, his name is Gustav. Let's just...
Hey, first of all...
I shouldn't hate
Gustav is Floki, all right? And if you never watch Vikings, it is the most baddest-ass show on network television
right now. It blows my mind that it's on History Channel.
So, like, the new World of Warcraft movie, the main star in that is actually the star of Vikings.
Mm-hmm.
I can't remember his name.
The new Warcraft movie was actually pretty good.
Oh, add that to the list, Matt.
We're in the show now.
I'm just saying.
We'll talk about it later.
It's okay. We can break the fourth wall.
I thought it was good.
They know we're just talking to them.
So, like, this is fine. God, what is his character in that shit? Is it Ragnar Lothbrok? It is what his name is.
Yes.
No, that's a dude from Vikings.
That is the guy from Vikings. That's what I'm talking about.
Oh, yeah, you're right. Yeah,
so
yeah,
he's
yeah.
the main character in the World of Warcraft movie. Mm-hmm. And, like, if you're not watching that show, it's actually a depiction of actual it's Viking history. And so it's the tale of Ragnar Lothbrok and his four sons. And his four sons are the guys who conquered, like, modern Scandinavia. So, like, the protector of France is actually his brother, Rollo. And his son Bjorn is like the conqueror of like Sweden.
That's
pretty
baller.
And his other son is like the conqueror of like
Norway. Oh god! One more show I have to watch.
So like, if you haven't watched it, it's on Hulu. I will give you my network password to go watch that show.
Oh, I got me some Hulu. I'm all about it.
If you haven't watched it, the first season is pretty decent. It's got Gabriel Burns as like the king of the Vikings, and he's like the Earl of his area, and like that he kills Gabriel Burns in that show. Like, spoiler, but it's fucking it's fucking incredible, like the show. And then the second season is so baller, man. So they do. There he is, Pentagon Dark is fighting Rey Mysterio.
Oh, okay. Shift gears.
So look at his chin gear is terrible, but look at Pentagon's uniform.
is he wearing bell bottoms?
I don't know, but look at Pentagon Junior, man, he's so fucking baller.
Oh god, he is crazy, dude. Look at his contacts. He's got
so cool.
This man has like white contacts in his eyes.
He has zero fear.
Zero fear. Anyway. So Vikings.
Like I'm telling you, look at this. Like, that's fucking amazing wrestling.
Yeah.
The Wheel of Misfortune. Like, that wheel is so chintzy. It looks like a fucking low-rate fucking... what's that show with Drew Carey? They used to take over from Bob Barker. Price is Right.
Yeah, Price is Right.
So he took over, like, the fucking low-rent Price is Right wheel, only you gotta wrestle, like, weird dudes for the title or something. I don't know.
That's exactly what that wheel does. That's, like, perfect.
So, but Vikings is an incredible show. Like, if you're not watching that, you need to watch it.
Yeah, man.
Is it like season four or something now?
Yes.
Oh, shit.
Season four.
Is it four?
It's four.
We'll see here.
You're about it, Quincy.
Season two, or season one, he becomes the Earl. Season two, he becomes the King. Season three, they conquer France. And in season four, they try to attack. So they're in season five, I think. Plus, have you ever seen the show The Strain?
No.
Actually, no, but everyone keeps talking about it.
So, like, one of the main characters from The Strain plays, like, Odin in Vikings.
Gotcha.
And he's, like, got these two roles. Like, so you don't get a real appreciation for how giant that dude is. But he's, like, the nondescript henchman and everything.
Nice.
I forget his name. Like, look him up real quick.
I'm going to see The Strain.
It's that guy.
Oh, Kevin Durand?
Yeah.
Oh my god, Kevin, yeah, he is. Holy shit.
He's like fucking gigantic too. And it's got the bad guy from the Ant-Man movie as like the main character. He's CDC scientist.
Yeah, it's what's his name from House of Cards.
So they basically this plane like just fucking lands in the middle of New York. And there's, like, everybody on the plane is dead and they're trying to figure out why. But it's because they're, like, importing the Vampire King to New York. Oh my god.
Oh my
dude.
God.
And
what
so
am I doing
slowly,
not watching this?
Slowly and methodically, do they start taking over all of New York with like these fucking. And they're not like just, like traditional, like I have fangs vampires. They're like the vampires from like Blade 2 where they hit like the jaws open, but there's this stinger that shoots out of their neck. It goes like 6 feet.
Nice.
And if you even get hit by that stinger, you're a vampire. Or you're gonna die. They just suck you dry. And here's the thing, too, is like the main character is a CDC scientist and he's like hanging out with some of his friends. And there's a pest control guy who's Kevin Durant in there, and he's like really good at killing these vampires because he's like totally, they think like rats, so like he's really good at killing them.
Nice.
And then there's this guy, a Satrakian, right? And he's a World War II concentration camp survivor. He's a Jew from like, and his whole life has been dedicated to the master because one of his duties at the concentration camp was he carved his ornate coffin. And because the guy is like super huge, like the master is like super huge, and it like totally jacked up his hands. But he spent like his whole life hunting down this guy, and so now you're in modern day New York as this guy's hunting him down. But you're like thinking about it, he keeps telling people 70, but you keep doing the math. It's because he's been keeping himself like healthy with the worms, because like, it's transmitted through these worms.
Whoa.
Things. It's so baller. Like the show is so well done, and it's like about science and vampire killing and stuff, and like it's more about the CDC stuff.
So Quincy, what are we doing not watching this show?
There are no soldiers and no badasses. It's regular people being badasses.
So wait, which network? I also feel like everything
FXX.
About this. Okay. So if I wanted to watch that on like Hulu or something, like...
I actually just finished season 2 on Hulu right now.
Okay, perfect.
So it's on Hulu.
No, okay. I was about to say, it sounds like we're just plugging shit the whole time. Like, you can watch this on Hulu, but that sounds super good. No, but
that's just stuff that's just it. Like, this is the shit we're watching. Cable, you can watch it on Hulu.
Yeah, exactly.
Netflix has not done a very good job of picking up some of those shows. No, they're all about their own original content.
Netflix is about their original shit.
Which, and they got some decent stuff.
Original shit.
Like, Stranger Things was really good. We talked about that the last episode. Yeah, we did. And, I actually, believe it or not, I'm not a really big fan of Daredevil. But I like the Punisher out of that. And I like Wilson Fisk, who's Vincent D'Onofrio.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I like some of the characters out of the show, but I think the show is kind of crap. But that's just my opinion. Like, I know people are really like, no, Daredevil is, like, one of the greatest things in cinematic masterpieces of all time.
It was entertaining. Wait, I think we talked about this when we hung out one time, too. We were talking about, well, what were you going to say, Quincy?
Well, I shared something on Facebook earlier today. I saw the trailer for,
Luke Cage.
And, like, it had the whole old school, ooh, baby, I like it raw, in the background.
Ooh, baby, as I like he's straight it raw.
Fucking people up. It's baby, insane.
I like it raw.
And then I also saw the teaser for Iron Fist.
Iron Fist is going to be my dude.
I think it's going to be legit.
And it's all leading towards Heroes for Hire, man. Well,
Defenders.
It's Heroes for Hire. Yeah. It's just fucking, it's that show is going to be so badass.
It is going to be badass.
And that's going to be one of those things. Like, I'm into Luke Cage. I'm into Iron Fist. I'm starting to get into these shows where, like, they're not talking about, like, the main characters of these, like Marvel films anymore.
Yeah.
We're, like, looking at, like, I could give a fuck about Wolverine, don't care about the X-Men. And by the way, in Marvel Comics, did you know that they just announced that the Terrigen Mist from the Inhuman stuff, how they make the Inhumans, has made all mutants sterile, so there will be no more mutants.
What?
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah, they're writing the X-Men and mutants out of because Fox. They're trying
to
write them out
because Fox is trying to ice X-Men from them.
That's really surprising. Like, I don't know. It might be surprising,
but if you're a huge fan of Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. and how the Inhumans have grown in that show, the Inhuman shit is going to be there's nasty.
Like, my favorite character is actually an Inhuman, the Black Bolt.
Yeah.
Where he actually can't speak because if he whispers a word, it can level a city block.
Oh, yeah, dude.
Like, it's fucking bomb.
I've seen... Like, I haven't watched very many of the Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D., But from what I've seen, I know who Black Bolt is. That's a character I know. And no, that shit looks crazy.
Yeah, it's
sorry, I'm distracted by these luchadors. Dude, that luchador's fit. I'm sorry, what's his name?
It's Pentagon Black. Yeah, Pentagon Dark.
He looks crazy as fuck. Sorry.
It's super good though. Rey Mysterio just tried to hit the 619 and couldn't hit it. But look at his glasses; they're terrible. Vampiro, you're getting so old.
Yeah, but, like, fucking, dude. Okay, so Pentagon Dark looks creepy as fuck. Vampiro does look... Like, what are those Vampiro's glasses, like, bro?
His trainer, and he's gonna go over there and, like, tell him he's his master and shit.
He looks like one of the... He looks like one of the Uruk-hai from Lord of the Rings.
Yes, he does. Like, he does.
He's, like, super...
My life for sorrow, man.
Yeah, exactly. Yes, fucking lurks and shit. Like, pulls a knife out of his leg. Those things are
fucking badass.
Because those guys are all, like, 6'5",
whatever.
They're
not badass. They got killed by the droves.
Those things were badass. They're,
like, supposed to be, like, a hit from a hobbit.
Like fucking, you got killed out by Frodo. Like, you're not bad.
Although... Legolas would, like, spin some shit. Like, he was pretty... He killed them
30 at a time. Like, they were counting. Like, I'm up to 52. Yeah, I'm like, I'm up to 107.
He would shoot him through the head, bro. Like, yeah, he's, I'm like, saying, that good. He's been around for hundreds of years.
They were fucking ran them down.
Yeah, no.
They ran
them
down. You know what I'm saying?
No,
they did straight.
But that's exactly what... What's his name? Pentagon Dark looks like.
Did you see that flip pile driver? I can't believe he beat my boy, though. As I'm sad. Fuck
Rey Mysterio. Anyway, ACL walking sorry, around. I'm sorry, I got like super distracted. I was like, Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. Well, we
Teddy Bridgewater.
wait. Who's the
Teddy Bridgewater?
Teddy Bridgewater is the quarterback of the Vikings. He just destroyed his knee, and so the Eagles gave away for a first round draft pick. Sam Bradford for.
We're like less than a week into the season.
Oh, he's gonna do it.
Okay, so we got Uruk-hai dude. Oh, he's gonna break it, dude. Oh my god, he's gonna break this gentleman's arm right now. Okay, no, he's tying his arms behind his back.
That's what it is. That's what it is. He's doing the armbar.
Oh my gosh. It's savage.
Zero fair.
Bruh, like. Oh, okay, he's rescued by, I don't know who that luchador in the green uniform with the green mask is, but
I think it might
he's got like a lot of energy.
I think it's Prince Puma.
Oh my god, okay.
Yeah, his,
that'd be a good transition, though.
What? Fucking Prince.
Fucking Casey Jones.
Oh, see, that's how just scripted the song. That's such a hard transition.
I know. Well, so this is the thing, because it's our podcast and we're drunk, like, we just get to talk to people,
let's
like...
Let's get some quality to it. Like, put some showmanship to it. Zero fair.
Zero fair. Zero fair.
So, actually, I want to talk about something different. I think it's something that we actually all watch and that we really enjoy. And so, the last season, or the third to last season of Game of Thrones actually just stopped airing not too long ago. And they just announced that the season's, what's it, 7? It was 7 episodes, and it's not coming out until, like, July of 2017.
Dude, I think it's like technically end of June, but it might be July.
The last season?
It might
second to last.
Okay.
Second to last. Only 7 episodes as opposed to the mere 10 that we've had leading up to it, which of course as like Game of Thrones fans, that's like garbage.
Well, first of all, I want to say this.
7 ridiculous episodes.
We've finished the George R.R. Martin side of things, right?
Mm-hmm. Which is weird.
And we've done this thing where look at you with your preparedness.
You know, I try.
So, but here's the thing. Now that we've eclipsed the George R. R. Martin things, we're not going through the regular book shit of, like, fucking, let's, like, flay the penis of your favorite character kind of shit. The season six wasn't really that good up until the last 2 episodes.
Yes.
Which is maybe the best television I've ever fucking seen.
That shit was awesome.
It was just awful. Shame. It was, fucking chain.
It shame. Was it was shame. Shame. Are you saying shame? It was one of those things that like
that shit was awesome. Xerxes,
first of all, let's go chronologically. The third to last episode, you have that meeting where Jon Snow and his sister Sansa Stark actually like meet each other, and they're so happy to see each other. But if you remember, Sansa Stark and Jon Stark have never spent
each other.
They had never spent a screen time
hated
together.
Jon.
But here's the thing, yeah, all of her family is dead except her half-brother, John.
Yes.
Well, and would you be happy if you just spent the last half a year with Ramsay?
And Arya.
And we ain't even going, Arya. No, so, Arya's fucking gangster.
So this is the deal.
Arya's
so
my chick.
She rolls up back to the north, and she gets to see a familiar face, and like in a...
Not a familiar face. She just spent a half a year with Ramsay Bolton.
Yes.
And then that's the first person she sees who generally
does... Wait a second. Let's go in chronological order with Sansa. Sansa has lived with nothing but lunatics in the last 6 seasons.
Except for Tyrion. I mean, but also Lannisters in general.
Tyrion's a lunatic, too.
Tyrion's a lunatic.
But he's like a much more... He's not like a much more...
controlled unit.
Children
lunatic.
Of the Corn, too. Oh, my God.
Oh, my God. This is what's on TV right now. Okay, muted. But anyway, so Sansa has spent a bunch of time with lunatics. But then, like... But you're right, Matt, in that she did not... I don't think they've ever been in, like, a scene together at the same time.
It was actually on the show, after the show, it was said by the directing staff that Sansa and Jon had never been on the screen together.
No.
And is why their hug was so cute.
It was actually it brought your heart together. And then they spent the rest of the time trying to get their army up together to go get back Winterfell from the Boltons.
Mm, mm-hmm.
And so, basically, they're going around trying to get... These houses are turning like House Glover and all this other shit. And that's when we cue into probably the most badass character that the show has ever produced.
Mm. Yes.
Lady Mormont.
Yes.
Is like the most baddest ass chick.
Yes,
ass
queen. Girl. Wait, hold
she's
on.
She's a badass. She basically sat in that meeting hall and said,
Wait. Chronological order.
Go ahead.
Chronological order.
All right, let me stop.
Okay. And then she's like, you know what? You guys didn't help out us when we needed your help. He's like, but you're pledged to our house. She's like, I don't think so. And then finally, the Onion Knight's like, you know, honor and belief and power. And she's like, we'll honor our house's pledge to House Stark. He's like, how many men can you provide? She's like, six.
she said 62.
Yeah, no, it's like some stupid ass.
She said 62.
What I love
too. They look at each other like, well. we'll take that.
this 10-year-old.
She's so funny.
In charge of Bear Island is just like a total baller, but with only 62 fucking knights.
Well, she don't give a fuck though.
But you think about it though, like some of the most baddest ass characters you've run into have been Mormon so far. Fucking Daenerys Stormborn's like older guy who like lives in love with her and keeps getting
damaged. Jorah.
Yeah. Jorah Mormon is badass. The commander of the Night Watch, the guy who gives Jon his sword, is a Mormon. So like the Mormons are badass folks, man. Like they're like a real cool people.
Like they're like, I want to say they're the Spartans of that world.
I wouldn't say Spartans. I would say more like they're the like Visigoth tribes. Like they're the guys like as like Rome is running through, like we're going to conquer Germany, and like there are Visigoths here. Like what's what is a Visigoth? And all of a sudden, several skull bashings and axe blows. Like, we must coordinate a strategic assault against the Visigoths. Like that's the Mormons. And so and what ends up happening is they basically they're gearing towards this war, the Battle of the Bastards, right? Where you're gonna have the bastard Snow, Jon Snow, fighting the bastard, Ramsay Bolton.
Right?
He isn't a bastard no more.
He's of House Bolton.
He's his House Bolton because he owns it.
But if you think about all the Ramsay Bolton's one of my favorite characters.
Ramsay Bolton's a fucking
because he's so easy to just fucking hate.
Yes.
And he's done some of like the worst shit to any character that you've seen.
Yes.
Like
my man, multiple characters. Like
my man
just
cut off the penis of Theon. And like
his name ain't Theon, first of all. His name is Reek now.
Right. You're right.
His name is Reek.
He also flayed like several people alive.
Yes.
And just like fed his stepmother
he
and
fed
her
stepmother
son to
and
his dog.
His stepbrother to his hounds.
Oh,
so essentially
God,
this
that made me that was weird.
This
like,
tiny
yeah,
army was from the Starks are gonna go face off against this huge army from the Boltons. And so the night before is like one of my favorite scenes where Tormund is talking to the Onion Knight.
Oh my God, yes.
And he's like, what do you do before a fight? He's like, I've got a jug of sour goat's milk. It's way better than that pussy drink that you guys. And he's like, what do you do? He's like, I keep walking and thinking and walking until I shit myself. Happy shitting.
Yeah, exactly.
But he's also like the fucking spokesperson for Travelocity now. It's
it's
kind of incredible. But like they got to line up for this fucking huge battle, right? And so basically they Ramsay sends out Rickon, and Sansa actually
in Ramsay Bolton fashion though.
But Sansa actually warns them about what's going to happen.
Yeah.
She's like, "Yo, he's going to fuck with you and you're going to fuck up." And he's like, "I'm way smarter than that."
Yeah, Jon Snow's
Snow's, how many battles have Jon Snow been in since the season started?
Well,
a lot.
I think too I think there's a sense going into it where Jon is like, you know, like, I don't have the most people in my army. I don't have, like...
He's just trying to win.
Yeah, like, or honestly, like, he's just trying to, like, get through this shit. And then even when Sansa's trying to, like, warn him, though, he's just kind of like, well, then what would you have me do? Like, blah, blah, blah.
How many battles have you fought? And here's the thing, too, is that the two battles that the two people have fought are so subtly different.
Yeah.
Like, Sansa survived to this point, and Jon has fought to this point.
Oh,
mm-hmm.
Jon's fought
and
his
so,
way
like,
to life.
And now, if you think about it, like, in this lore as we're sitting right now, Sansa's like that like, broken queen kind of character.
Yeah, sort
of. Yas queen.
Yas queen.
So, but Jon is, like, legit, like, legend now. Like, he's killed White Walkers. He's beat back the North people, the wildlings. He's fucking survived like so many
giants.
Different...
He's even bridged the gap between the wildlings and the Night's Watch, which
he's
has been
still
like
died
super
and come
fucking
back to life.
Yeah, exactly. Like he is exactly.
Let me give you an idea of how badass Jon
Snow
is. Right, Jon Snow has come back to life. You're right. Like we skipped that, right? But he's also the guy who's so badass the wildlings are like, hey, let's follow that fucking guy from One Direction.
Yeah.
With his pretty hair.
You
follow
don't know
the guy
your
with
hair's
the pretty
beautiful.
Hair.
Oh, man. There's another movie called, MI5, Spooks or some shit.
Oh,
like
where
that.
He was in that, like...
It was so bad.
Wait.
So Kit Harington
was
in
it.
Kit Harington was in it.
Oh, my God. I didn't even know he was in
anything.
It
was so bad. It was such a bad spinoff.
I've seen him in
terrible.
Those, I think they're Lexus commercials. And he's like, you know, he still just looks literally like Jon Snow driving a car in a suit. It's kind of silly. But So, okay, Battle of the Bastards was amazing.
So, here's where they, like, line up for the battle, and then this is, like, the first large-scale battle in, like, all of the entire Game of Thrones, like, world so far, like, you've been able to see.
Yeah.
Right? Like, they haven't had a large-scale battle. Like,
what about the one...
It wasn't as big as this battle. Blackwater. Like, it wasn't, like, an open...
Yeah, Blackwater. So the thing with Blackwater, too, is that, like, it didn't... There was a very,
a
like...
courtyard? And a naval battle.
Right, right.
It's the first ever open field battle.
Right, exactly. Like they're meeting each other in the middle of this fucking field. Yeah, exactly.
And Ramsay fucks his brain so bad.
Yeah, he did. He did.
Like, legit, Ramsay Bolton sends out Rickon. He's like, we're going to play a game. Run to your brother. But you've got to run. And he's like...
he's like creepy as fuck about
and
it.
And the whole time you're watching
God.
He starts running, you're like, motherfucker, zig or zag or something.
Serpentine. Like,
you need to zig. And then the motherfucker zagged when he should have zigged and he got hit by
First of all, let's talk about Ramsay's entire setup before this battle, right? Let's talk about what did the battlefield look like. So here you got this stretch of dudes, and they've got a German. They've got a tauntaun, right? And
It's 1-1. Yeah, they have 1-1.
A 1-1, right? They have a 1-1, and it's pretty imposing. And then you look at the other side, and there's just this fucking army of dudes. And there's like fucking 40 people on the upside down X, just flayed and burning. It's like,
they had people to spare.
Came to fight for reals.
They were like, I'm sorry, you can't come to the battle tomorrow. We're going to flay you and use you for intimidation. Like, they, like, lit that fuck up.
You also going to die?
Yeah. Oh, fuck.
So, like, all of a sudden, like essentially, John goes out to go rescue Rickon, and of course, Rickon gets hit by the arrow before he gets there, and then John has the freak-out moment and tries to charge, but he realizes it's too late and the arrow is fucking coming.
Hang on. This moment, too, where he's, like, riding up, and then he takes, you know, he's of course like off his horse because I think they shoot his horse out from under him or something. And he's like standing in front he's like standing just mere like meters in front of them. And he's like, oh, fuck, it has
Well, he doesn't
moment.
Even, oh, fuck. He doesn't even know fuck. No, he's just looking at this thing and just fucking as badass as he possibly could.
Sword
just
out.
Fucking pulls his sword
he
out.
Does,
just
it's,
the sheet.
It's because
Snow
he knows. He
and
knows.
Let's do this shit.
There is this moment of
ham on those dudes, yo.
But there's this John moment Snow's of like shit. Certain death where he's like, you know what? I'm
gonna
die.
I didn't think he was gonna die at all. I thought he was gonna swing that sword and take a couple people out before he went.
He, I think you're right though. He was definitely standing there in the face of certain death, just like
this is about to end.
I've died before.
Yeah.
I've been here.
So, oh like, and then all of a sudden the fucking battle clashes and then, like, do that whole phalanx formation around them.
The unsung hero.
Because here's the deal, too. Like, everyone back on the line saw Jon Snow and they were like, oh,
protect
we're gonna,
your king.
Yeah, like,
yeah.
We're gonna,
like, they're sitting there watching this, like,
protect
your leader.
And then they're
and
like,
then
oh,
I was
we're
like,
gonna have to
protect
help.
Your king. And
it
gonna, like,
it was protect your commander. Like, all you
we gotta help homeboy out because he's about to get wrecked. And so
here's my favorite part of this is that I think it's the part that goes really underwhelming about this episode. There's so many highlights, right? And Jon Snow is getting trampled in the mud as this phalanx is, like, closing in around them and forcing them in, and he can't breathe. And this whole time, Jon's had this huge thing about, like, he's been resurrected, but he never wanted to come back. Mm-hmm. Like, he was okay with being dead. Mm-hmm. And now he's, like, forced back into this world of the living. And as he's, like, he's coming out of the circle, he's being reborn as the real Jon Snow. As he's coming out, he's trying to breathe again, and everything's crushing around him. He comes out of the circle, and he's reborn, and he looks over, and the fucking knights, the veil comes scraping across the side.
You know what
he
reminded me of?
Dude,
Lord of the Rings?
Yeah, Lord of the Rings.
Lord of the Rings,
yeah.
The two towers, as Gandalf stand at the top of the hill.
With the Rohirrim.
And you see the fucking Rohirrim come down the fucking mountain.
Oh,
that's what that shit reminded me of.
It's the Riders of Rohan.
Yeah, the Riders of Rohan.
That's right. No, that was my bad.
Sorry, geeks. You
we'll get it
Lord
right.
Of the Rings, Greeks.
Fucking.
My bad.
So here's the thing, too, is that as soon as those knights come around, you look at Ramsay's face, he's like, I'm fucked. And he goes back to the house, right? And so all of a sudden, he's inside. He's like, we can hold this fort just for a fucking fortnight.
No, and here comes the unsung hero, that motherfucking giant.
1-1?
One play of the game.
Beautiful
came
man.
Rolling through that door. And then Ramsay's look on his face was just like, oh, I'm fucked.
And then the fleeting arrow flies through his head as he's laying there dying. And Jon Snow just looks at him and he fucking snaps.
Yeah.
And he just fucking starts walking towards him. And he goes to draw his bow and he picks up the shield arrow, blocks it,
She keeps rolling through him. Arrow blocks it. Keeps rolling through him. Goes to drop another arrow and like throat punches him with the shield.
Yes.
Sits on his chest and just lays down the beat down.
And then kept him alive though.
No, here's especially the thing: is that when they did that scene for an entire day, right? And they said, and the guy whose name was like Ewan, yeah. Actually got punched in the face like 30 times that day, for realsies. And this so man. Like and as he's like beating this dude to death, he like looks up and Sansa's there, and he realizes that's not my kill.
No, he's dude. Like, yeah, that's not
and
mine.
And Sansa's like looking on at like Sansa's, her like legally bound husband who's been torturing her.
Ah, it was beautiful.
Seeing him like
bloodied by
this man who is her half brother, and she's like, I'm about this. Like, just
here's the
all
thing
of
too,
that.
Is that at
and
the
like,
very
you
end
you
of that
see
episode,
them make eye contact. She's like, yeah, let me get that.
Yeah.
At the very end of that episode. For all the times you've seen Sansa be, like, rejected, you thought she was going to come back as, like, a power heroine. Mm. Like, you thought she was going to come back as, like, a great character. And you've hated her, and you thought she was so weak for all this time. She completely redeems and changes her character
in
that one moment.
She becomes her mother.
Hold on. No, hold on. We're missing the part two where she was responsible for all the Riders of the Vale coming in and like
was she
and that
though?
Whole
yeah she was
yeah,
yeah she, I mean she was responsible but I mean
no. She has the look of responsibility like she is like
she
I did this
finally manipulated Peter Baelish into doing
which is
something
fucking
for
yes, beautiful exactly. too because you take the most
manipulative
master character on the show Peter Baelish and like you know Sansa has no she's learned the game like this is the game. Yeah. And she gets it.
Peter Baelish, though, is, like, at this point where he's still trying to manipulate her, but he's having trouble because he made her, like, too strong.
Yeah.
Right? And so
yeah, because
that's
she's
where,
too good now.
That's where you get into the, like, probably... I thought this should have been the season finale until I saw the season finale.
The season finale.
And that he's sitting, he wakes up, he's drenched in blood, he's tied to a chair, and he's like, Sansa... You're fucking, you're here.
You're talking about Ramsay Bolton.
Yes.
He's like, are you going to release your hounds on me?
Oh, because he mentioned.
And she sits there in the smug look and she's like,
you said they
you
haven't
said
eaten in a week.
Self. They haven't eaten in 7 days. I was like, oh,
this is so savage.
And that,
so
that,
good.
That,
so
that
savage.
First bite where he like takes out the jaw. Mm-hmm. And as she's walking away as the fucking dogs are eating him, she cracks that little smile.
Yes. Oh my god.
That was,
boom. Can I just say like
oh,
Sophie
god.
Sophie Turner, just like as a human being, I'm like, oh my god, like, okay, she's always
she's
been, like, cool, whatever. But then, like, all of that shit happened, and I was like, oh, my God, Sophie Turner.
Bamboo shoots in the cornfield.
Yeah, no, I saw that. But anyway, Sophie Turner, sorry, we're watching Children of the Corn. It's on the TV. That's on right now. But she is just, like, this, like, amazing, like, powerful, like, sexy powerhouse. Also,
she's Jean Grey in the new X-Men, too.
Which I'm about.
Which I'm about as well.
So I haven't seen it, which is dumb.
It was good.
I need to because
I haven't seen it
Sophie
yet either,
Turner
but I'm about
though
it.
Sophie fucking Turner.
So she played a good
so
Jean,
cue,
young Jean Grey. Mm.
So stop that episode.
Okay.
Cue the season finale. Right.
Cue it.
And we have one of my favorite characters. She wasn't one of my favorite characters before this moment, right?
Wait, you didn't like her before this?
I thought she was tolerable.
Who
are we talking
her.
About?
Cersei
you know,
Lannister.
Oh, Cersei? Oh, man.
Cersei's savage as fuck.
I
so
liked
savage,
her,
bro.
But
she's
I didn't
so
I didn't love her
until oh, okay.
this moment.
Until this moment? Yeah.
Right? And so they're doing the whole, like, trial for fucking Margaery's brother. And, like, they're all inside there. And they're going to call out the queen to come down there. And she's going to be into her trial as well. And she's, like, looking at the fucking, the high priest or the high septum.
Yep.
And she's like...
The sparrow.
She's not here.
She's
because
not
she,
going to
she's
care.
Not, she doesn't want to be here. Right? And so, like, you're looking at this ridiculous shit. How down? So, here's, I know there's, like, a weird transition here that I'll edit out later. But, here's, like, you're sitting here in Game of Thrones, and Margaery's about to have that whole, like, meeting.
Mm-hmm.
I'm sorry. I'm gonna start it all over. So, here's the thing. Cersei's not going to her criminal trial because she just isn't, right? And so she sends the Mountain to go stop Tommen from coming, too, because some shit is going down. And then proceeds to be probably one of the most epic 5-minute segments of a TV show I've ever fucking seen.
Yes!
Game of fucking pianos.
Yes.
That so, music like, leading up to it.
So, like, here, like the Harris, the her cousin and the High Sparrow's, like, number one dude is, like, following this child down. At the same time, there's, the, like, the who's it? The high, like, the council guy. Master Pycelle or something like that.
Master Pycelle.
Right.
He's getting led down, and like, so it's like she does this coup
right.
where she like literally eliminates all of her enemies in one fell swoop.
Yes.
And she does it with probably the most baddest ass Dragonfire incident like ever.
Well,
like,
possibly one of the only part was definitely in that my kingdom.
Man following.
Well, because of the Dragonfire, they had that the Battle of Blackwater.
They had it set up. Like, so this is the deal. And we learned about this, I think, in the episode of Battle of the Bastards, where someone, I can't remember which character mentioned, but they're like, oh, I heard that the Mad King had Dragonfire set up all over the city.
I think it's the creepy dude who's, like, the guy who made the, like, zombie mountain.
Yeah.
And so, like...
Sounds about right.
So, like, they do this thing where, like, the guy's, like, trying to crawl over to, like, the well, candles that are lit over there.
That. Before that... He's following this kid down here in the sewer.
So from yeah, from the tower. He loses him.
So he's sitting up here looking around, and all of a sudden, my favorite part,
kidney shake.
This little kid comes up and is like, "Shake, bitch!" and then ran off. And he's sitting there just dying and bleeding out, and like all these candles.
You're talking about Master Pycelle,
and
right?
As he's crawling over there,
It was one of the little birds.
As he's crawling over there, right?
He's got this little candle.
All of a sudden, like, Master Pycelle's down. He's like, "I really wanted a better death for you than this." And then, like, the kids all pull out these knives on Pycelle, and he's like, I'm about to get shanked." And so a kid tries to run up on him. He like punches him, and he doesn't get the shank down.
And then all these little kids are just like, shaking the shit.
Oh, dude, he was really savage.
It was brutal.
Legit blows up like a tenth of the city with fucking dragon fire to kill her enemies.
Yes.
And of course assassinates Pycelle.
Chill with all of it.
And
yeah.
She just grins through the whole
thing.
Yeah,
exactly. And her awesome, like, black fucking, I don't know, like her like nice dress robe.
In school at the time, but the time when I was watching that scene, as soon as she like stands there, she's grinning. I'm like, "Yas queen,
yas queen." Dude, it was like that smile on her face is what made it.
The only sucky part is that her son
like,
lost like the love of his life.
Wait, here's the thing. So total puss move on King Tommen's part.
Yes. Like he's fucking total pussy, but he lost the love of his life, and he's just looking out over the city as it's burning, and he sees the smoke.
It's falling. He realizes
Marjorie was there, so he looks out the window, and his mother was
never going to let him live.
No.
With that decision to back the High Sparrow over her.
Oh, absolutely.
And it wasn't that she would kill him, but she'd just control him, and he didn't want that.
Right.
So he steps out the window.
I'll let you go through. You guys can discuss. The Daenerys Targaryen and the Greyjoys joining forces to sail across the sea.
Okay. Oh my god!
There's one thing that I have to be the one to deliver because I fucking called it.
What?
I fucking called
it. Oh, I know exactly what it is.
So I'll go ahead and deliver it. So as all this bullshit is going on, as we know, the Greyjoys have hijacked their uncle's fleet. Because he is now the king of the
Which,
Iron
by the
Islands.
Way, the, one of the most baddest lines in the whole series is, like, he finally gets the Drowned King kingdom, where they actually, like, fucking go out and drown
and
him.
And they drown you, bring you back. And so this is the uncle who, like, murders the existing...
It's Euron Greyjoy.
Yeah.
Let's go kill my niece and nephew.
Well, that's just it. Dude, he comes back from being drowned, and he's like, he's the king. He's like, "Where are my niece and nephew? Let's go murder them."
Yes.
It's like, that's my homie for next season.
Yeah.
That's the dude.
So
the Greyjoys have hijacked his fleet. They're on their way to Daenerys. As you know, Daenerys has just killed the Masters of Yunkai.
Yeah,
She's running that shit.
She's been tested. Her dragon, all three of them.
Drago has come back. Drago is actually mining Daenerys at this point. She can ride him whenever she pleases.
Yeah, get it.
She's riding back to Slaver's Bay on Drago. The Masters have started attacking.
And then of course Tyrion's like, "Oh, I can explain," and then it's like, "Oh shit, everything's fucked up
and it's my fault."
Yeah.
Well, like they finally decided to do a meeting on top of the pyramid, right? Mm-hmm. Like the Masters of Yunkai show up and they're like, "You know, we've come here for your terms." We're like, "No, you misunderstand.
we've come here for your turn.
It was so good. Yeah. It was so good.
And so, like, just the dragon shows up, and he's like, I want you guys to elect which one of you guys you're going to kill.
Right.
And they're like, we're going to kill this dude because he's not one of us.
He's so lowborn.
And fucking
Grey Worm. Grey Worm slits the dude's throat.
Yeah, like.
And then as Tyrion walks by with his hands behind his back in that whole Tyrion fashion, he's like.
That's when you know that Tyrion's truly... the voice of the queen. Yes. Like, he's truly the hand of the queen.
So good.
And let's, by the way, let's go through the fucking hand, when she hands him the hand of the queen thing.
Yeah,
that
like, was
she
cool.
Names him, like, that was one of those things, like, he was that like, was I'm, not, like a, and, I'm not like a, I'm not like a good man, and but I truly believe in you kind of thing, and I'm never gonna leave. Like, I'm never gonna tell you bad advice. And she's like, I know.
Never gonna let you down.
No, I'm never gonna give you up.
No, so, as this is all over, she destroys you. she destroys the Masters with her dragons, Trump, all right? Three dragons at that. They decide to make her sails with dragons on them.
I pointed that out to you with the hilted in gold.
Yeah, and like, and they were hilted in gold.
The Greyjoys were hilted in gold with krakens.
Yes.
And hers were in red dragons.
That shit was cool. So she's making her way to King's Landing. She's making her way to King's Landing, which I've been waiting for.
You're talking about Yara Greyjoy? Or you you're talking about Daenerys.
Daenerys. The interchange between Yara Greyjoy and Daenerys was great. She's like, I believe his terms were he was going to come give you his big cock.
So, right. So, can I just say, as, like, obviously, like, as a female, I'm like, cool, like, female characters who, like, are awesome and not, like, total wimps. Not that, like, they're, you know, I don't know. Game of Thrones is always cool about that. So we've got Yara Greyjoy, whose name has been changed, I think, from Asha Greyjoy. My little sister who reads the books points out, and she's always really salty about it.
You know what, though? She has a good point, though.
No,
she does have,
like,
a good point on that character.
She's very savage about, like, oh, I need the books, I don't watch the show, so.
But you should watch the show, because it's an entertaining show.
I know. She's like, no, it's boobs and dragons, and I'm like, yeah, exactly.
So what are the books?
Yeah. Boobs and dragons, maybe with more penis, I don't know. Like, yeah, some playing, like. So anyway, yeah, what were you going to say? I'm sorry.
So I'm going to gloat in my fucking righteousness for a minute, right?
Oh, Lord.
So we get to a scene where Bran is doing, he's finally watching that scene where they're at the Tower of Joy, and Ned Stark's walking up, and he walks into his sister, Lilyanna Stark, right?
Mm-hmm.
And she's giving birth to her son, but she's dying,
right?
And so if you remember the prophecy of the whole the god of fire, right?
Mm-hmm.
Is that the savior of the world is going to be born under a star, and he's going to share two bloodlines, right? He's going to be the Song of Fire and Ice, right? And
which
so
is the whole series.
If you look
by
at Ned
way.
Stark's sword, right, at the foot of the bed on the top of the hilt of his sword, right, is a sun, right? The sun is a star, right?
Mm.
And so they go through this thing where she tells Ned that she had a kid, and she makes him promise, because if Robert Baratheon ever finds out who the father of her kid is, he'll kill him. So she swears him to secrecy, right? And they bring over this child, right? And you hear her say that it's Rhaegar's son, right? Rhaegar Targaryen.
Mm-hmm.
And they fucking do this scene where she makes him promise, and they bring the kid, and they hold him in the screen, and they look at his eyes, and all of a sudden, Jon Snow fucking pops up on the screen, and every fucking prediction and fucking call out that made were validated in that very moment when you found out.
Which, here's the deal, that's how you know we've surpassed the George R. R. Martin part of this, because it's like very servicey to the fans, but at the same time, I know every foundation, like all of this going into it, has built up to
so that. we get a cue into the secret, because at the end of the episode they do this thing where they talk to the directors, and the only reason George R. R. Martin allowed them to do the show was because they correctly guessed the lineage of Jon Snow, and they called out that Jon Snow was the son of Rhaegar Targaryen and Lyanna Stark. So it's not Jon Stark. It's fucking Jon Targaryen, right?
And it's another name too, which a bunch of people I can't remember what it was.
It's one of the names of the ancestors of the Targaryen family.
Right.
And so they go into this scene, the super badass, right? Where he's calling for them to all come to arms, right? And that the real war is coming, and they bring the storm,
they're not the storm. They bring the storm. And so, like, nobody's kind of... Because all the houses that, like, defected from the Boltons, and they're now standing in there, they're there to supposedly pledge their fealty to the Stark house again, because they think that they're going for Sansa Stark, the lastborn of... Because they don't know Arya survived, right?
Yeah.
And I'm saving that for you, by the way.
Oh, thank you. thank you.
They're looking at each other, and they're, like, calling out, like, we're not going to do this, we're not going to do that. And then fucking Our Lady Mormont stands up, and she's like, you know, you motherfucker. When
with no nuts.
when House Stark made the call, you didn't answer. House Glover, they, like, skinned your father. Like, when they answered the call, you didn't answer the call. I know no king but the King of the North, whose name is Stark. All hail Jon Stark. And so they, like, then they stand
the
up,
wolf,
like,
the White Wolf of the North or something. And I was like, yes, I'm about that. Yes.
They're like, the guy stands up. He's like, Lady Mormont's words are harsh, but true. And so they start doing this thing. So like, and they do this whole, like, epic montage where these guys are, like, pledging their swords. Just like,
dude, it was
my king, King of the North. And they just start doing, King of the North, King of the North. It was so bad.
We recognize only one king, and it's the King in the North. Or what? Yeah, it was just, like, super good.
So, there was one other scene that was really dope, and it might have stole the, like, that, first of all, like, I had so many chills and, like, those, like,
no, just, I stood up with my laptop when awesome. This happened, because it was one of those, and I just, like, walked around, I screamed, like, I was, yes. like, I couldn't, so, like, yeah, no, I was yelling, all kinds of yelling.
Are we talking about my favorite character?
We're talking about your all favorite right. character.
By far my favorite character. Yes, she's been through her
ups
and
downs.
Let's
build it up first. Let's build
it up. I'm gonna build it up.
Talk about with the Lannisters meeting the Freys, and then build it up. Like, okay.
So with the Lannisters meeting the Freys and everything, so the Freys, as you
are
know,
are, like, super gay for the Lannisters.
Super gay for the Lannisters. They'll do anything for the Lannisters. They pretty much fuck the Starks completely.
Mm. The Red Wedding with the fucking
Red Wedding.
The song of the Casimir. Yeah, Reigns.
One Stark goes down. They killed their mother. The Freys have just fucked everyone. Kitten. You know what I'm saying?
Kitten. So cat on the show. Sorry.
As we know, Arya is pretty much in her assassin's training. She's trying to become...
She already escaped from Braavos.
A woman with no face.
But you don't know this yet.
Yeah, we don't know that she's actually escaped from Braavos. But apparently she has.
Last you saw her, she had a gut wound.
Yeah, she had a gut wound.
She was like parkouring all over the fucking city with a gut wound.
Yeah, and she gets in this room and it goes dark. We don't know what happened to Arya.
But one of the coolest scenes about that whole thing is when she goes up to the man with no face. And she's like, you know, she puts the fucking the waist.
Oh my god! It was
and he's
fucking...
just like, all right, you. All right. I see you.
Yeah.
You know what? Your business.
I'm handle your thing.
And secretly, even though she was supposed to become part of the Men with No Faces, he's proud of her that she's fucking ascended to this level.
Exactly.
And he's about to send her on a fucking. She just goes for a quest for revenge.
So Arya has basically completed her assassin's training. She's gone somewhere. We don't know where she is. So you see Walter Frey. He's like, I want my food, and he's calling for his sons, and all this bullshit, and this girl comes up and says, oh, here's your food, Mr. Frey, and all that bullshit, and as this motherfucker is eating that shit, this chick says, oh, they're right here, if you're calling for your sons, they're right here, they're in the pie, as he's eating it, and then all of a sudden, it cuts back. And Arya's standing there and slits my man's throat.
Because
that
so she peeled off a mask and it was like, she had.
She doesn't just slit his throat. Yeah. She doesn't just peel back the mask. She peels back the mask, grabs his head, slits his throat, and makes him look at her while she smiles.
Yes. She's epic.
She's so good.
She's the shit.
Also, can I please point out, like, so okay. Backtrack just a step, just a slight bit. So, Yara and Daenerys were, like, they were all chatting, and everyone was like, oh my god, gay undertones. And it was, I'm gonna be honest, it was really hot.
It was pretty well. You want
it
the bullet?
It was super hot.
Mm-hmm. Here it is. So, I want to go into prediction land, right?
Yeah.
And so I want to make my call-outs for the next season, right? So, here's my big call-out.
So you know how Euron Greyjoy was going to go down and try to get Daenerys to be like his queen so he could ride over and conquer the world?
Yes.
And that now that there's no heirs to the Lannister fortune, that Cersei is the queen, I think he's going to redirect course and he's going to marry a Cersei Lannister.
You think
I think that the battle's going to be Euron Greyjoy and the Greyjoy fleet.
Yeah.
And Cersei Lannister and the Lannister army, which is still the largest army in the land. Versus Daenerys, the fucking Unsullied, the Second Sons, which she left behind in the town to protect, but she's also got, like, a load of other armies there. I think that's the big battle.
You think that's the big battle?
For next season.
I can see it. Second to last season.
The Sand Snakes. That's who I was thinking of.
Sand Snakes. Yeah, they're going to show up too. But
all three of them.
The spider recruited them.
Well, mm-hmm. I think Jon is going to probably just stay north and start to build his army there.
I think
for what's coming
with like the wildlings.
I think you're right, but I think once he wins, that they're going to make their march down to King's Landing, and that the big final battle is going to be between Daenerys and Jon, and that you're ultimately going to see either the Lord of Light, who is Jon Snow. Who's resurrected,
yes.
Who is the one born under the sun, who is one of the Song of Fire and Ice, versus the Queen of Dragons, the Breaker of Chains, and just the Stormborn, and just fucking that is season 8. That is the final battle.
I
think they're going to figure out that they're
George R. R. Martin has always been like super like, oh yeah, like I'm going to write women as like really, really strong characters, whatever.
Sometimes.
I feel like No, this is the thing. I feel like because we have surpassed him, we're going to see Jon.
Well, he's advising on the new shows now.
I would hope so. It's his fucking character.
Well, he gave
them
the ending in case he died.
Right. Which is hilarious, too.
Oh,
because,
really?
Yeah, yeah, oh, yeah. He told D.B. Weiss and David Benioff. He was like, hey, in case I die, here are the things.
So that's what I think is going to happen.
I would not be at all surprised if like Jon Snow were on the throne. However, I would also
here's the thing
love
between
Daenerys
the two of them
or Arya.
Between the two of
or
them,
Sansa,
well, I think Arya is going to end up becoming the hand of Jon because her and Jon's relationship was super good.
And that's right; they were like best
and
friends.
She's going to be that ruthless motherfucker.
Oh, dude, she's
so
ruthless. Savage.
I don't
she
think
is so
she's
savage.
So ruthless. I don't think she's going to live, but I think and here's my call: I think she's going to kill Tyrion.
Now, how do
no,
we...
I don't think she'll kill Tyrion.
I don't think she'll kill Tyrion.
No, I don't think she'll kill
Tyrion. Oh, God.
Tyrion.
Every prediction he's ever had on the show, though, has been right.
I don't think she'll kill Tyrion, though.
It has been right, though.
I don't believe that. No.
This is
Tyrion
my thinking.
Will live throughout this.
This is my thinking. She's already getting her revenge, so she's definitely going to kill the Mountain.
But Tyrion
except
isn't on her
not,
list.
Except she's not going to kill the Mountain.
Tyrion isn't on her
here's
list.
Here's the thing, though.
You're right.
Here's
Tyrion
the thing.
Tyrion
he's
isn't on
her
list.
List. He's not
on
the
list. Who is on her list, though?
Cersei Lannister.
And she will kill Cersei.
Oh, it's going to be so good.
She will be the one to kill Cersei.
Fucking good.
I think that Daenerys is actually going to end up killing Cersei.
No, I think Arya is going to get to her first.
It will be Arya.
Dude, I hope so.
So here's my thing.
Arya is out for blood, dog.
So we're missing a major character, right?
She's out for blood tonight.
So we're missing a major character in a major group, right?
What?
The Brothers Without Banners.
Yes, yes, well,
okay.
Yes, we are.
And what major character came back this season?
The Hound.
The Hound came back.
God bless
him. So we're going to get a Hound v. Mountain fucking season 7 matchup.
Which is so sad because they're brothers.
And you know what it is? You know
but
what
his brother's the reason
on,
his
wait.
Face is jacked.
Wait.
Yeah, you're right.
Wait.
Oh my
wait.
God.
And you know what it will be over? Because he has the slightest love for Arya, and that's it.
It's not slight. It's huge.
It's huge.
He loves that little girl.
Like... And I think what's going to happen is that Arya's going to bite off more than she can chew against the Mountain because the Mountain is on her list.
That's why I'm thinking that when she goes to fight, she's going to be incapacitated for a while, right? And then that's when the war between Daenerys, because I think that the Brothers Without Banners are going to come swoop in while Jon's fighting the White Walkers.
Oh my God, that's right.
I think they're going to have to fall back. They're going to lose Winterfell again, and they're going to have to fall back to King's Landing. And that's where you're going to get that combination between Daenerys and Jon Targaryen. But I think that the issue is going to be... I'm just calling it canon now.
Yeah.
the issue is going to be that John, she's going to be like a despot by the time that's end. And so the final season's battle is going to be a true despot Targaryen versus the King of the North, right, as for the final battle. But I think that it's going to end up being Daenerys that kills Cersei. Because ultimately, I just think that that's the way the writing's going to end up. Because you never get that kind of vindication, that validation. Dude, that so one true. Character who kills the character that they're supposed to kill. With the exception, like, nobody ever really thought that Jon was going to be the one to kill Ramsay, right? And until it was made abundantly clear that they were going to fight, like, that was never on the radar.
No, you're super right. Like, I never would have... I would have never guessed.
I thought Ramsay was going to be, the like,
real,
a huge
the
part.
Real thorn in that side is going to be Euron Drake Greyjoy, because Euron is a fucking psychopath, right?
Yeah.
So I think that Arya's going to end up killing Euron, or maybe Jon's going to kill Euron, right? But I think that Cersei's going to get killed by Daenerys. And I think that to get to the throne, to the Iron Throne at the end, if you see a Jon Stark or Jon Snow ending to the throne, that Arya's the one that ends up taking out either Tyrion, and that Jon ends up killing Cersei or Daenerys, but Daenerys also has a very equal chance in beating Jon as well.
Oh, of course. So, I mean, like, their sides are so strong right now.
The only other fan theory that ends up being accurate is that because the Targaryens were known for intermarrying so much, that Jon and Daenerys end up hooking up and becoming the rulers of the New World together.
Right, right. I see that happening too. Yeah, that's like a whole thing, yeah.
But that's just my theories. I was right on a couple. I was wrong on a couple too.
No, but you were right about
it. I don't know. I feel right about a lot of stuff. I feel like you were right about the majority.
Especially
Arya breaking away.
Arya's thing, whole thing where she's running. Like, and then, you were right about that.
Yeah, oh yeah, all of that.
I had a lot of really good call-outs, but like I have a way of thinking about things. That she's bleeding from his earballs?
Sorry. We're watching Children of the Corn. Oh my god.
There's so much Kool-Aid coming. Oh, voodoo.
Oh. This creepy kid... with, like...
Mattress. Oh, look at all that Kool-Aid. Old people looking at you. Okay.
People looking at you. Anyway,
so, talking about, like, this is a horrible tragedy we're watching right now. Talking about horrible tragedies. Dicks out for Harambe.
Like that priest. Dicks out for Harambe.
My man Harambe was assassinated at the Cincinnati Zoo. It's just horrible. Horrible what they did to Harambe.
And this is a thing that occurred, like, months ago, but I feel like it gained so much attention on social media. But just, like, okay, so people were expressing themselves on social media.
So,
and it was like, everyone was really outraged.
So, sort of outraged. Pretty outraged, right?
I feel like people were pretty outraged.
I'm genuinely embracing the joke of Harambe. Like, it's something that you can easily troll people with. It's absolutely wonderful that I have this opportunity to make people think about a gorilla, right?
What?
Like my fantasy football team is high caliber Harambe, right? Oh, man. Which is funny on multiple levels. Because it was a high caliber round that took him out.
Yes.
Right, but my man Harambe was assassinated.
He was our hero, and so this is a thing, too.
He had an opportunity to change the world.
Like...
Our fallen son Harambe.
So I love all the social media that's like dicks out for Harambe, blah blah blah. Like, I think that's like a really...
You don't understand dicks out for Harambe. You should put your lady dick out for Harambe.
I mean, right, like, so, here it's flopping out. So it's out right now.
You put your dick out for Harambe. That's so Harambe when he descends from heaven can touch you with his almighty gorilla ball sack. All right.
okay. Fair enough.
And caress your face with his gorilla dick. Okay. You honor Harambe with your dick.
Also, why on earth did a child wander into... Like, I think this was, like, part of the questions that, like, the news was asking. But they're like, oh, you know, blah, 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 we're gonna gloss over it. Why the fuck was a kid in Harambe's enclosure?
Because his ghetto-ass mother let him wander into the fucking pen.
No, stop it. Stop it.
That
okay.
is absolutely true. So, okay, so at the zoo...
I don't like, Quincy, the term ghetto-ass mother.
I've been to the zoo.
You've been to the zoo, Quincy.
No, I'm just gonna let you know. I'm just gonna let you know. Watch your fucking kids.
No, you're at the zoo. That's like how it goes anywhere ever.
There are lions there.
Here's the deal. When you have children, like...
I'm sorry, I was less than 25 yards from a cub lion dragging around a piece of a cow leg. I mean,
Heyo, dicks out for Harambe. No, this
watch
is,
your fucking kids.
This is yeah. This is the thing. I feel like this should apply to like.
I will all say of at the North Carolina Zoo though, there is no falling into a pin.
No,
in the
gorilla
I, pin. Polar right, bear. Like so
the polar
I'm,
bear you might be able to fall.
No,
in.
I'm not.
Fall into
so
the polar bear.
Tall kids.
Yeah, tall kids good.
Here's the deal. I'm not a parent, but like. I don't know. It's the same with, like, the kid at Disneyland who got eaten by a fucking alligator or whatever. He was at the hotel. Like, watch your fucking kids. Don't let them, like...
Here's the problem, right? I'm a fucking wreck, and I'm a parent, and my kid has never been in danger.
You're, like, a
at
really
a public
good parent.
Outside.
No.
Quincy, you're a fucking wreck, and you have a kid. Has your kid has ever been in danger at a public setting?
No.
Like, have you ever
because
dropped
you fucking
your...
watch your yeah. kid,
watch
right?
My fucking kid.
There is no situation and
like,
zero possibilities
like,
I'm
always
thinking circumstances
it's not even,
that my kid could
and
have
the
fallen
thing
into
is,
a gorilla explosion.
It's not
explosion.
Even just falling into a gorilla explosion. You don't know the motherfuckers that are around you. They can snatch your
Dude,
kid up at
it's
any time.
So true, though.
I'm not even worried about these fucking animals. I've seen them before. I'm watching this
Where
kid.
Are the animals that you're watching around?
You know
well.
What I'm watching? I'm watching this little animal that's two or 3 years old that can't,
that's
that
a
doesn't
badass
understand.
Kid. Don't you follow that kid. That's no, a badass kid. No, that kid's going to get eaten by a gorilla.
Like she started running.
But
and
not my man
like,
Harambe.
Like, we let her go
Save
for like,
peace.
She's two. She can walk.
Our hero Harambe.
But we let her go for like 2 seconds. But it was just like, she was in eyesight and I saw her running. So I headed off into a sprint. And it was just like,
we have like a 6'4" man like running after like a 2 or 3 year old.
I let my kid run ahead of me at the zoo. Like she's yeah. been like a good 50 feet for me where she was like running up on shit. But it was in areas, see. It was areas that there's no way she could have gotten through the enclosures.
No.
I don't know. Yeah, like, well, no, all of that. Like, I feel like parents, like, I just don't get how a kid ends up in
because
an
you're
enclosure.
Ghetto-ass parent.
No, don't say ghetto. No,
super ghetto.
No.
My kid's scared of shit at everything anyway. Like, even when I'm holding her up or something like
my
that.
My kid's afraid of shit. She'll fucking arm wrestle that gorilla.
That's
yeah. She would have walked in and poked him in the eye. Like,
actually, Matt. Nah, I can see your kid doing that. Like, I can see your kid
my
just
kid has
being
zero
like, no.
Zero fair.
Took her to the science center. You know how the science center, they got those big-ass fucking tortoises?
Yeah.
So mm-hmm. I was like, Genevieve, look. She was like, no, motherfucking no. No, no.
No, that's an animal.
No, that bitch is moving too fast, and it's just too big.
It's a tortoise.
No, you gonna hold me, and you gonna hold me back. We ain't getting no closer than that. Like, you should just, you like, she. I can feel her shake. She was like, nah, that's
like,
too close.
See, that's what a
it's
zoo...
It's too close, man.
That's what a zoo or science experience
should
be. So
my kid was at the petting zoo. She won't go up to the fucking goats. The tamed goats to pet?
Oh, no,
she
doesn't go
like,
up to the goats.
She's like,
she thinks
uh-uh.
they're like dogs. She started laying on them and shit.
Uh-uh, I ain't touching that goat. I'm not going to my eyeballs. Nah.
But true, though. What is wrong with the goat's eyeballs?
Meh.
But okay, so that's the whole thing. Like,
should go up
kids
and brush goats
should calls. Just not end up in fucking.
I don't watch your fucking kids, man.
Yeah,
simple?
Yeah. Just keep an eye
ghetto
on them.
Ghetto ass.
Stop
parents.
It! No.
Watch
not
not
watching
stop
they
it.
Fucking
stop.
Kids.
Watch fucking kids.
Also,
I mean,
there
like,
were okay.
I might
so,
not have been in a situation where I had
so,
like five there, but at the same time, it's just
I'm ghetto as fuck, and I'm still
you're
watching.
Your fucking
yeah,
kids.
Exactly. Here's the deal. I feel like also like okay, so these ghetto ass parents who let their kid get. Pulled in by
oh,
a gator.
Converted.
No.
Actually,
get,
I'm gonna explain something to you. Anybody that's in Disney World ain't ghetto, because that shit's expensive.
Right. But I'm saying, so the kid who got expensive. Pulled into a pond at the Disney
man,
resort,
if you're a Florida resident, you get a fucking discount.
Florida man. That. Oh, that's like a good.
You read into my transitions.
Here we go.
Transitions, you crazy person.
I'm so sorry. It's because we're like so similar. So, here's the deal. There is a Twitter devoted to people of Florida.
Hold
and...
on a second. Before you get into that, as a former resident of Florida, mm-hmm. whenever we hear some dumb shit go off
try
on the
to,
news...
Try to like, justify your shit.
So, man robbed a KFC by trying to jump down the grease chute and was mauled by leprechauns. Like, please don't be from Florida. Please don't be from Florida. I know they're from Florida.
It's always from Florida. It's always from Florida. Okay, so here's the deal. So Florida Man is its own Twitter. If you have not started following it, it's wonderful. It is like its own superhero because every once in a while, you know, in the news, you hear a ridiculous story And maybe one out of three times. Like, man tries to
arm wrestle crocodile for fucking crack.
Man eats person's face off.
Or prescription drugs in Florida.
Or bath salts, I don't know. But anyway. Bath salts. So certain things. Also, there's Florida woman.
I would be happy to say that one of the drugs I've never done is bath salts. It just seems like a bad idea.
I'm so proud of you. I'm so proud. You need like a badge or something. Like
I think there's like not have done bath salts badge in Boy Scouts.
Okay, wait, let me see here. All right, we're good.
I never did crack, I never snorted meth.
So, these are certain headlines. Armed Florida man. Sorry, I'm too close to the mic. Armed Florida man found roaming around park dressed as tactical police dinosaur.
Wait a minute, what is a tactical police dinosaur?
Exactly what you think it is. Wait, let me look at this.
Please tell me he's in that fucking Tyrannosaurus suit with the fucking
Okay. Oh wait, this is the better description. Dressed as a dinosaur arrested with assault rifle. Yeah, you know he was in that
Tyrannosaurus. Probably not an assault rifle, probably an AR-15 or armor light rifle.
Okay, also
which we've been over, yes. And that's a fucking assault rifle, you fucking
not an assault rifle. Assault rifles are automatic.
He's an armed police dinosaur. Come on now. He has a right to be there. Okay, wait.
He's just trying to take care of evolution. Florida, don't worry about him.
Florida man caught eating meth-soaked drawings in jail. How
else do you eat drawings?
Right. No, you gotta eat them.
That's also just logical. Like, you gotta eat the meth-soaked drawings. Like,
how did he have meth-soaked drawings in jail? This is probably... Well, this
first of all, let me describe jail to you. And then let me tell you, butt-smuggled meth is not an uncommon thing.
No, it's not. Mm.
Right, Florida man arrested for assaulting his manager with frozen hamburger patty. Matt, if I could think of all the times that I wanted to assault our manager with my hard meat, then, you know.
What?
But I actually going into the interview for the position. Manager position of a certain elite group of computer analysis people. Actually, if you haven't heard this yet, I don't think,
no.
Asked if the manager who has just recently been promoted to the GM of that store was gay to his best friend who works at my store.
Huh?
Is that manager gay?
Well, he has two kids and he just had one, so I hope not.
Here's the deal. There's no shame in being gay. Like, obviously, like, who, you what? Know.
Hold on a second. I'm going to explain something. And you're going to hear a slight, like, delay, and then you're going to hear, oh...
Record.
Tell me.
I know what you're talking about, man. Right.
There's no shame in being gay, but obviously that manager was not gay.
Unless you're actually gay. Ninja Turtles movie made by Michael Bay.
Alright, hold up.
First of all, number one, for the folks who haven't seen it, you know.
Hold on,
I mean?
There's no, no stop that. It. There's no shame in being gay. I just slapped my friend because all right, both of us. Sorry. Talk about your lame
Intentional digs.
wait, I'm too drunk to care. Talk about your Ninja Turtles movie.
So, here we go. You love the Ninja Turtle movies. And you know what? I'll give it to you. You can love the Ninja Turtle movies all you want. Hold on a second. Couldn't make it through the first movie. Okay. I actually turned it off.
Fine.
And we were talking about the ones by Michael Bay with Megan.
The first ones, I get it. The origin story was fucked up. I get that. That's cool. Fine. Whatever. Right? Origin story was real fucked up. Let me throw this at you.
The origin story of the Ninja Turtles?
The origin
fucking
story?
Fucking turtles and ooze raised by a rat. Origin right. story complete.
With guess pizza. What? Don't guess forget
what?
The pizza.
Guess what? They honestly weren't hit with the fucking ooze in this. There were no fucking ooze. Fuck that.
I know, they're genetically... hold on a second. Let me pull my sobriety
turtles.
Together and say that they were genetically movie. Engineered by Megan Fox's father.
Yes.
Kill me now.
Exactly.
Bushido complete.
Okay.
He gave them all...
Fuck that. Alright, we established that the fucking origin story in Michael Bay's version of this movie was fucked up. That's great. But this second movie... Compared to the second movie of the original Ninja Turtles, the movies they started coming out with Toga and Rezar, who the fuck is that? because there was no Token Razor in the Ninja Turtles cartoons. There was Rocksteady and fucking Bebop. Rocksteady and Bebop in this movie was Seamus.
Seamus and the black guy?
Yes, and they were funny as fuck. It was Rocksteady and Bebop. It was fucking crazy. I'm telling you, give this movie a chance if you're a Ninja Turtles fan.
Is it on Hulu?
Give it a chance. It's not on Hulu.
Is it on Amazon Prime? Watch it on Prime?
Cody. If you have Cody, you can watch it.
What? I don't know what that is.
Super Pirate.
Super Pirate. So if you have an Amazon Fire Stick and you have
Oh
Cody,
my God, stop. Is stop. A great. I swear we are not supposed to talk about that as human beings.
I'm sorry. Last time I checked, we're the Fat Entitled Bastards and we don't give a fuck.
And I'm completely okay with piracy. I'm just trying to figure out how he can get me Cody on my fucking Fire Stick that I haven't bought yet.
I can do it in 5 minutes sitting right here.
My
Fire Stick.
Will it go through my Roku TV though?
No.
That's
my
problem.
My favorite thing about Fire Sticks is that
actually no, it will. You just have to change it to that.
Yeah, exactly. You gotta change the whole. You probably have to reconfigure that shit. Mm-hmm. You got a good router. Anyway, okay. Pirating.
You looked at me when I said Toga and Razor. You looked at me like I didn't know what the fuck I was like. You didn't know what the fuck I was talking about.
Okay, Toga and Razor.
Wait a second. Hold on a second. You know the whole Vanilla Ice Go Ninja Go Ninja Go.
Wait.
Go ahead. Go ahead.
Caitlin, who are Toga and Razor?
I don't know.
Have you ever seen Ninja Turtles 2?
No.
Back to the Ooze?
No.
What?
I haven't.
We have a mission.
We do have a mission.
We have a huge mission.
I'm going to go ahead and order it at work. I'm going to get the fucking triple set DVD come in Blu-ray.
Oh my God.
And we're going to watch it.
Okay. You've seen the Ninja Turtles cartoons, right?
Yeah.
Old school Ninja Turtles.
Yeah.
I'm talking about like Krang.
She doesn't know what you're talking about.
She doesn't know what I'm talking about. Oh man. Like, alright. For you 80s kids and early 90s, who grew up watching the Ninja Turtles,
guys, I'm gonna be
Transformers, G.I. Joes.
I was literally born in 1991, and I wasn't even allowed to read Harry Potter in 1988.
Remotely close to our age.
Like, Jesus Christ.
I kind of am, but like my parents...
I'm so sorry.
No, my parents really made me like not...
She doesn't have a mission.
She doesn't know about Skeletor.
We have a mission.
Do you have any idea to who it is that you speak?
Help me. I gotta fix it.
Snarf.
Well, I know that from...
Hold on, I can do it perfect. Hold on a second. I got it.
Snarf, snarf.
I can do this. Hold on a second.
Thundercats. It's Thundercats.
Yeah,
I can do this. Hold on a second. Hold on.
Lion-O. Snarf, snarf.
I got it, dude.
I mean, it's like...
Lionel, right. What are you doing?
Do you want to know why Vanilla Ice got famous?
Now, first of all, if you're about to say because it's Ninja Turtles, you're wrong.
I am wrong, but, I mean...
His first song, Vanilla Ice, the whole plagiarism of the fucking Under Pressure song from David Bowie.
Oh my God, Mick Jagger.
His second song...
No, it's not Mick Jagger. It's fucking Freddie Mercury from Queen.
Yes.
Under Pressure...
Oh my God, I'm a disgrace. I'm drunk, but I'm also a disgrace.
Vanilla Ice's second song, why it got so hyped,
Go Ninja, Go Ninja, Go Ninja, Go,
right? So,
Cowabunga.
Yeah. So, like, in the second movie, like, when we were coming up to the second movie, everybody thought that the mutants that Shredder was going to make, they were going to make
Rocksteady and Bebop.
And Rocksteady, right? Come to find out, this motherfucker makes some shit called Toga and Razor, which, me, personally, I thought that was fucking stupid.
It's a snapping turtle, and there's another one. Which is the other one?
It was like a fucking hyena or some crazy
shit like that. It was
like a weird fucking dog. But Rocksteady and Bebop are a warthog and a fucking rhino. If that movie had Bebop and Rocksteady in it, it would have made it 20 times better.
First of all, as a kid who grew up in Europe in the early stages of my development, we only really got three shows, which was...
Speak Spanish! No, I'm just kidding.
Speak Spanish.
Speak German!
Different part of Europe.
Different part of Europe.
Speak French!
Schmetterling! That means butterfly in German. Krakenwagen! That's ambulance.
That sounds like, fucking in the back. What?
So,
For me, I only ever got Ninja Turtles, Transformers, and G.I. Joe.
Okay.
Those were the only American cartoons that came through.
Those were the main three, though.
And then when I got to the States, it took a while, and then I saw Dragon Ball Z, and my life was over.
Yeah, exactly.
But
I was raised under a rock with like super conservative parents.
You have like ultra mega super duper conservative parents. So like, it is our mission in life to introduce to you the most amazing things from our childhood.
I'm about it.
Which will be severely underwhelming. And
except
that Ninja Turtles cartoon was fucking dope, man. No,
the Ninja Turtles cartoon was dope, but it was so ridiculous.
With the fucking what's the cruncher like the mini rat fucking with the Foot Clan. What are they called? They're called like the Bowsers or Mousers or something.
Something like that.
Probably Mousers.
You had my man Dr. Fly. You had Casey Jones. Casey Jones used to roll around with a motherfucking hockey mask on. With a bunch of shit in this little like duffel bag.
Who was like the new like generic white dude in like the Michael Bay?
Who was Casey Jones?
Stephen Amell.
Stephen Amell from Arrow. Yeah. And he played Casey Jones awesomely.
Brother.
Even though they fucked up Casey
Side Jones. Note, Quincy is totally gay for Stephen Amell.
I think Stephen Amell can act, he is a boner just talking about
Stephen
it.
Amell
it's
can
weird.
Act. But I'm just saying this.
You know how I always say that Idris Elba can have my beehole anytime he wants?
Wow.
He's all about Stephen Amell. He's like, he writes Stephen Amell fan fiction.
First
of all. I've read it. It's real. It's super real.
Either way,
Relax yourself. Get some lube. That's what they say works.
The first Casey Jones that they made in the first Ninja Turtles movies, he was awesome. I don't even know who the fuck the actor was. I was way too young to even give a fuck who the actor was. But Stephen Amell, they fucked up his fucking character because they said Casey Jones was a cop first, and I was like, "Nah, that's fucked up."
Nah, he never was a cop. Yeah,
you fucked that up.
Wait, in the Michael Bay movie?
Yeah, in the Michael Bay, I was like, "You fucked that one up. You fucked that one up hardcore." No, sorry. He wasn't even a cop. He was a corrections officer.
Pause. Any positivity you say towards this movie forward from now is complete crap.
Why?
Because my motherfucking hatred towards Michael Bay says
that
we just can't say that's legit.
You can have your hatred towards Michael
Bay. He's trying to change.
I'm telling you.
Hold on a second.
And it's a Michael Bay produced movie. It wasn't even directed by him.
So he probably was not involved at all.
He's trying to say my boy Casey Jones' origin story is different. And I'm trying to say bullshit.
Yeah, it is bullshit. And that's probably the only bullshit part. We can agree
to disagree on that.
When we talk about Krang though, Krang was spot the fuck on. Krang was spot.
Like,
I haven't
CG
made it that far into the movies, man. They're just that bad.
I'm just telling you, you need to give this one a shot.
I feel like this is one of those Fast and Furious situations.
No, we didn't talk about that.
Where you're trying to legitimize Little Bow Wow to my life.
Oh, man. No, Tokyo Drift is... No, that shit sucks.
Shut up, Quincy.
That shit sucks. I did not like Tokyo Drift.
You gay for Bow Wow?
No, absolutely not.
What does your tattoo on your lower back say? You want to suck Bow Wow's dick?
It's a dragonfly, which is Southern girl white trash, guaranteed to do anal trailer park shit.
That's like you eating Winona Ryder's
booty stuff.
That's what Quincy thought.
That's how you get hepatitis, my man.
Or AIDS.
So, like, let's talk about some of those movies that were not so good. Like the Ninja Turtles or Fast and Furious.
Mm-hmm.
Did you see 47 Ronins?
I did.
That movie was trash.
That movie was straight trash.
That's
probably Keanu Reeves' worst movie. But that's saying something.
First of all, Keanu Reeves came out with The Matrix, the first one, baller. Right?
Next two,
stupid. Right? Mm-hmm. Then he came out with 47 Ronins. We're skipping all material between that, right?
Point Break was great.
That was before Matrix.
Yes.
First of all, we're talking about the time period after Matrix.
After Ronin 47 and after?
There was only one movie that he's been really good in that has come out after that.
Baba Yaga.
Oh. No, up.
The Baba Yaga.
John Wick.
I don't even refer to him as John Wick. He's the motherfucking boogeyman.
Right, so like he's only been in one movie since then that was really good that you were like, oh fuck, I see you, Keanu Reeves.
John Wick was awesome.
Here's the thing though, how much you know about Keanu Reeves?
A lot.
What do you
that,
know?
That he doesn't age at all.
That so he's looks, a Dracula. He's a Dracula.
He is a Dracula.
Right. What else do you know about Keanu Reeves?
I know that that dude is like, he's all into martial arts though.
Yeah, but did you know that he doesn't actually collect most of his paychecks? He gives most of them away to like charity?
No, I didn't know that.
Brother.
He lives in a regular sized house.
Well, I mean, like...
Right? Wait, hold on a second.
When you say regular sized, you
mean
like...
I don't mean like a mansion. I mean like a two-bedroom house in New York.
Well, okay, so...
Not in like downtown New York. I'm talking like Albany, New York.
So, okay. Okay. Wow. That actually makes
upstate
me...
Upstate New York?
Not upstate. Like, fucking regular... Like, so, like, everybody tries to, like, generalize New York. And as a guy who's from that area, like, everybody's trying to generalize New York as New York City or, like, Albany or upstate New York. And
he's,
like, there's, like, a whole fucking other side in New York. I'm talking about 90% of New York is not that spot. Right? So, he's, like, from a fucking, like, a small town in New York. He fucking has a regular house. He gives away most of his money to charity. And he just, like, chills. He rides the Metro. Like, he just fucking... He just chills.
I have seen that. Where he straight up looks like John Wick riding the Metro.
Like, legit, Keanu Reeves is, like, one of the coolest, like, regular dudes, like, ever. Like, he's, like, a legit just good person. Like, when you look at, like, actors, like, that guy's a piece of shit. And as much as you hate his movies, you're like... And when you find out what Keanu actually does, like, on a rig, like, that dude's actually, like... really fucking cool.
Yeah, no, I believe it.
But 47 Ronin was trash.
Yeah, it was trash.
And here's the fun thing too, right? I'll drop some history on you, some science.
Oh no.
Right? So what do you know about the Code of Bushido, right? Like if you lost your master as a samurai, like you had to kill yourself, right?
Right.
That was a secular group of samurai.
Right.
And was not their traditional samurai culture. No. Right? Samurai traditionally sold themselves out to the highest bidder as mercenaries.
They were mercenaries.
Right? So even that movie is trash. Even the Legend of the 47 Samurai are trash.
That is actually something unexpected for me.
So, Caitlin, you brought up a movie in the pre-production that we were going to talk about, Wanted.
Oh my god. Okay. So travel back to...
You go.
The year, I think it was like, I don't even know what year, maybe 2007.
Wait, I'm gonna let you finish. Are we talking about the same movie? Where...
Angelina Jolie.
Angelina Jolie.
Because there's one good part
fucking,
in that movie, and the rest
James
of the movie
McAvoy.
Is trash.
Okay.
I was gonna say Professor X, but you said James McAvoy. Yeah,
go ahead.
This is the deal. I remember that movie. I talked to like an abundance of friends. Everyone, like every review I read, was like, "This movie's amazing. Mm-hmm. This is the best fucking movie of the summer." And I remember this was after like my cousin and I watched it, and we both were like, "What? Did we all see the same movie? Like, did we see so common?" Like,
I'm gonna give a short synopsis of this movie. James McAvoy's at work, finds out his dad's an assassin, but not really. Said that they killed his dad. Trains to curve bullets, ends up finishing the movie in the same way it started.
So this
just
is...
like I could do shorthand John Wick too. Guy gets his dog killed, kills everyone, gets a dog.
Well, because like because so all of the details in between.
But he kills
like,
him way more badass.
That though. Shit. Yeah, exactly. And this is
Neo
this
from
is...
the Matrix gets his dog killed.
Yes, exactly. Neo gets his dog killed, fucks everybody up. Gets another dog.
This
and a new car.
This is the worst part of Wanted, is that everyone loved it, and it was like, everything's going to defy physics. I feel like I'm talking much slower
Why does it defy physics?
Because we were in that whole Matrix
because
era.
Because you can't curve a fucking bullet?
Right.
Yeah, you can't curve
because
a bullet.
Not around a room of like
no
13
matter,
people.
No
like,
amount
you
of
can't.
Wrist flicking can curve a bullet no
and,
matter what
and
shape.
And it was, maybe for me, it was one of those like coming of age movies where I was like, oh, like this is really wrong. Physics or like whatever wise, like writing was garbage. But every one of my friends was like, you see that movie Wanted? It was so good. And I was like, are you fucking serious?
All right,
like,
first of all, here's what I'm going to say about that movie. Only thing that was very funny in that movie, and this is what I'm going to say. So this guy portrays to be his best friend, and he fucked his girlfriend. So he goes to work.
He smacks my man in the mouth.
Yes.
He smacks Chris Pratt, and it says fuck you.
And yeah. I was like, yes.
I gotta call shenanigans. I gotta go Google that.
It was Chris Pratt. Thinking like, oh, like all of these random ass people. Of course, at that time.
Speaking of Chris Pratt. It was Chris Pratt. He got smacked in the mouth with a keyboard.
And it said fuck you by James you. By Professor with his tooth X. You.
Yes.
So I have a different favorite part of that movie.
What's that?
At the end is like, if you don't believe that, then shoot this motherfucker.
Yeah. Shoot this motherfucker. Yes. That was Morgan that Freeman. Was yeah, oh my god. Fucking
How many destiny calls did we do? This is the other thing
that you just reminded me of with the fucking I can't oh fuck what are they called where you spin like the cotton on like a or
the
like
loom,
a,
the loom.
Yeah the loom yeah. the magic loom
the magic and would, loom that would tell would, you who to kill
yeah, exactly. it was complete bullshit. Even like the logic in the movie was
they even said the loom was bullshit, it was just garbage. I gotta pluck this hair from your head. It's bothering me.
Oh.
Is it on my hat? Yes. Oh, okay. There you go.
It was blonde.
As a matter of fact, the dude walked in there and said, so what you're saying is this loom is complete bullshit. Cheers. He was like, yes. Yes, it was.
So, with the Morgan Freeman motherfucker in that movie, that was like, shoot this motherfucker right here.
Dude, I gotta text my cousin right now. That shit's so good. Like,
all right, what about The Departed? See, I thought this movie was trash.
Super overrated movie because Martin Scorsese is... He consistently makes
Hold
movies...
Hold on a second. Martin Scorsese has made some fucking classics.
He has. Mm-hmm.
All right, some real legit cool-ass gangster movies.
Right.
But this movie was super trash, and I'll tell you why. So did you know that Jack Nicholson rewrote his parts of the script?
What?
So that he would fuck more chicks inside the script?
Fuck off.
Is that the most Jack Nicholson shit you've ever heard?
Yes.
The only thing more ridiculous is when you told me Marlon Brando had to read his script off of...
In The Godfather? Absolutely he did.
Yeah, he had to read his script off of everyone's lap.
So first of all, think about the most iconic actors that you've ever heard of, right? If I say Robert Duvall, right?
Mm-hmm.
That's one of the best actors ever, right? He had to read his scripts off of Robert Duvall's chest because he wouldn't memorize his lines.
Yeah, he like refused to.
In The Godfather.
Who did?
Marlon Brando.
Are you serious?
I can't even talk, I'm so drunk. Marlon Brando.
I didn't know this.
Yeah, dude, it was ridiculous.
Tell me what you want on this day, the day of my daughter's wedding.
It was like a thing. Like he had to probably read that off of.
Watching the children.
Cool. Yeah, no, I got right super distracted. I'm so sorry.
Speaking of, like we said, Chris Pratt, right? Who's excited for this movie, Magnificent Seven?
Here's the thing.
I'm scared of it though. Here's why I'm scared of it. We've already had The Hateful Eight,
which by the way was one
which
of
was
the,
wonderful.
The best movies.
One of the best movies.
A pile of crap, but just an awesome movie.
It was so under the radar. Like if you haven't seen Hateful Eight, check it out.
Amazing.
We've had The Hateful Eight. If you haven't seen Ridiculous Six, which is on Netflix, you can watch it.
It's so crap, but funny.
Tyler, what was his name? Taylor Lautner plays a fucking retard.
Magnificent Seven was based on a movie.
They're all brothers, which is funny.
So you're about to say that the Magnificent Seven was one of those old school
Western shows.
It's a Western show, mm-hmm. and basically
They're trying to make it like a PC version of the Magnificent Seven. And while I'll say this, that I think that the highlight of that movie is going to be Chris Pratt and also my man Denzel.
Yes.
Right.
That's what I was saying. Like Chris Pratt.
The rest of the movie is going to be crap.
And Denzel Washington are in it together.
The plot's going to be crap.
It's probably going to be crap.
The story's going to be crap. The gunfights are going to be crap. Like, the movie's going to be crap. Like, I could just... I'm gonna go watch it, but, like, Denzel will do a good job, but it won't be believable based on the time period.
Right.
And Chris Pratt will be funny, you know, in this Chris Pratt ways, but the movie's going to be crap, man.
I would even question if...
I just
want
to know what y'all's thoughts were going
to
be.
Hold on. No. I would even question whether, like, Chris Pratt would be able to deliver his shit.
So what we're saying is we haven't learned our lesson from
basically,
Suicide Squad.
It's basically going to be Star-Lord.
Oh, no.
Star-Lord in a Western is what it's going to be.
Okay.
I feel like he's going to try to be more intense, though, just based on the previews.
Watch the previews.
No, he's not. No.
He's like, I've always wanted to blow something up, and he's got these, like, serious eyes, and I feel like they're trying to sell him more serious than he is.
But, here's my thing, too, is that movie is... they're trying to do more spaghetti westerns because I think that's the oh my god, a chick in short jean shorts and a t-shirt. They're going to get kilt for sure.
Mm-hmm. Sorry, Children of the Corn 2? What is this?
Yes.
Yeah, I think this is the sequel.
White kids in the country? Dead.
Wait, that's the only kids in the country.
Well, white suburban kids, sorry.
Yeah, super kill. Yeah, oh yeah.
Is she famous? Who is that?
Nah, she's like a gross, like random ass white kid.
Gross?
Yeah, dude, her nose is weird.
I did
anyway.
That.
Damn.
With a cinder block, yeah.
if that's what you want to call my dick, that's fine.
that's not what that kid's there thinking. He's thinking, oh, this chick looks like a golf ball through a water hose.
That's a good
because look at his fucking
hose.
Hair. Mm-hmm. He's from 2001.
Sucks start a Harley.
Anyway.
Call to my man, Mike, from back in the day. Mm-hmm. That's where I got that from.
I only said that because this woman is, very basic.
No, she's like, yep.
Nah, she's trying to get down.
Let me get that knowledge.
She wants to make an investment in the alphabet, considerably the letter D.
So this is
the encyclopedia.
So The Departed, right?
Oh, yeah.
Leo, I'm glad he got shot and killed in that movie. I'm fucking so glad all those Marky Mark gets killed. Mark lives. It's not Marky Mark. It's the fucking brother.
Yeah.
Right? That movie was trash. How about The Underworld?
Oh, my God. Okay.
All right, man.
Can we please talk
about...
I'm an
Underworld fan, though. I like Underworld.
So this is the deal, especially around this time of year. Stop it. We're heading into... We're heading into fall season. I do love, shitty, vampire movies, whatever.
You know what? Nobody loves B-movies more than me. We're talking about a guy who traditionally watched things like Dog Soldiers or, Mansquito. Or shit.
Mansquito?
Also, Kate Beckinsale can get it, exactly what Quincy was saying.
Here's my call.
Watch that movie,
Caitlin,
just for Kate
I'm going to call you out.
That's fine.
Is that you told me that Kate Beckinsale sounded older.
What's your problem, bro?
So in the newest... 50. Stop it. Hold up. In the newest trailer for... I know, I'm seeing this fucking white person. Anyway, this
She's
shit
about to give
on...
her the corn cob.
Children of the Corn, and they're about to get murdered.
She's about to get a corn
cob. So this is the deal. So I was talking about, in the preview for, what is it, Underworld Blood Wars... I was like, oh, either Kate Beckinsale has been, smoking more, or she's getting older, which I understand.
Because it's,
also,
10 years after the movie.
Boobs.
And also,
boobs?
No, there are no boobs.
What?
Just calm
down. This is L. Ray. There's no boobs on network television.
Yeah, there are no...
He's getting that
anyway.
Feel, though.
Yeah, he's feeling...
Who
is
that long of lingerie?
What is up? No. They're, a special
It's like a
short.
Weird super garter belt or something. That's not sexy.
Anyway, no. Anyway, so her voice sounds a lot deeper in the newest, preview. And I was like, okay.
Now she's getting uncomfortable?
I'm talking... Oh, there's zombies. There's zombies in Children of the Corn 2? I don't know what this...
That's not zombies.
That hand was getting... It's copping a feel.
Why is that hand alive, though?
Now she's buttoning it back up oh, my sleut ways are fucking... We know
you
no
stop
sleuth.
Stop it! All
but the sleut in the north whose name is Swift.
But anyway, Kate Beckinsale
sleut
sounded...
North.
She sounded a little older, and I felt bad for criticizing her in that way because people grow older, whatever. And she's still so tall.
Here's my thing: You try to be so PC, but you were like, she sounds older. It came from such a genuine place.
Your heart
was breaking.
She sounds older, or like she smoked more cigarettes, apparently that's like a thing that she does.
Here's the thing, too. Did you know that the dude who plays Lucien in that show, like the fucking the werewolf king, is actually Lucien? Her baby's daddy?
What?
Yeah, because her kid looks exactly like him. Nice. It's like amazing.
It's legit, like the fucking werewolf dude from Underworld. Dude. That's her legit baby's daddy.
You're talking about like the hybrid.
Yeah.
No, not the hybrid.
Not Michael.
You're talking about Lucien.
Yeah, it's her baby's daddy.
Okay. Yeah.
Okay. I like the weird, like, because they're not together, but they do, like, weird family photos for Christmas and shit.
What?
Yeah.
And so Len Wiseman, the director of all those, most of those movies. You're fucking
super detailed into this shit.
I just know his name. So, of course, he's cast her, like, multiple times, and now they're in this new movie, and it's, like, weird because...
The movie looks terrible just from the trailers.
Yeah, and it looks bad. They've got like Theo James from like the failed Divergent series or whatever the fuck it is.
That series just, like, failed epically.
Like, really?
They thought that shit was going to be the new Hunger Games.
Yeah, they did. They truly failed.
They made three movies.
Yeah, they made three movies because they were contracted to make three movies, and the last two absolutely tanked.
So they all failed.
Yes.
Wow. Yeah. Oh yeah. So anyway, so she's got Theo James and
no
she
amount of
even
Ellie
Goulding
can
Steven.
Save that fucking series.
No,
they don't even have
Ellie
Scott.
Goulding, Bass Nectar, none of that can save that movie.
Yo, did you know that Ellie Goulding had been called out for fucking Skrillex?
What?
Yeah.
I believe it.
I think that's one of those superstars. Like, ick. Him and his shaved
sidehead. Kate Beckinsale can get it. What else? Okay.
Trying to change the subject.
Either way, movie's gonna be super fucking trash.
How about super fucking trash? Anything starring Vin Diesel?
What is that about? Too, like, it sucks.
Hold on,
because...
man. Hold up, man.
Hold up.
Here we go.
We're talking about the same dude that said he liked the motherfucking Witch Hunter. What?
I didn't like it because of Vin Diesel. I said why I liked it. I liked it because Frodo was in it.
Yes,
Elijah Wood was in it.
Elijah Wood did screw Vin Diesel in that movie. That shit was kind of
epic. It was epic for a minute.
That shit was epic for a minute.
So,
I just imagine Elijah Wood
with the exception of
Vin
Pitch
Diesel.
Black.
Pitch Black was good, though.
Mm-hmm. Pitch Black is like 17 years old now.
Doesn't matter. That movie was good.
Like, Pitch Black, shit. I was like 14 when that movie came out.
Yeah, this is true.
And now mom took me
yourself. You just ate yourself. Anyway,
I was like 14 when that fucking movie came out. Awesome. That was the last Vin Diesel movie that was worth a fuck.
Awesome.
I live my life a quarter mile at a time.
You didn't like any of the Fast and the Furious.
They were
all
trash.
You're so stupid, dude.
I enjoy them because of their nostalgic.
Oh, man, whatever, man.
Because of their nostalgic value, I like the Fast and Furious.
You know what movie? You know what movie was trash?
That's like saying I like watching Schindler's List every Saturday.
Do you stop it?
Do you know what movie was trash for Vin Diesel? But they're bringing back Triple X.
I can't wait for that shit.
It's gonna be so garbage.
Xander Cage. Xander Cage.
Is it Xander Cage?
I think it's Xander Cage. Let's Google it.
Welcome to the Xander Zone.
Let's pull you googly. You didn't think I knew what a you googly was, did you? Hold on a second. Xander Cage. It's Xander Cage.
Is it Cage?
It's fucking 100% Xander Cage.
Okay.
Oh, that movie was trash. The Ice-T remake was trash. Everything is trash.
No, it wasn't the Ice-T remake. It was Ice Cube.
Ice Cube.
Everything is garbage.
Even though I thought the Ice Cube one was better.
Do you not have the bullet?
Even though it had terrible
Arvin
CGI.
Diesel.
I don't see the bullet over here.
It's in my lap.
Oh. See, you're calling for the bullet.
Twist top?
No, it's not a twist top. Okay. Fucking, oh my God.
That's
no,
a
man.
Real
I ain't never drank a dirty little freak before.
I'm sorry. Oh, God.
I have to punish you. This
speak
is your punishment.
For yourself.
Drink the whiskey.
No!
Yeah.
Drink the whiskey.
No.
Punishment whiskey.
You have to drink.
I'm not drinking whiskey.
Oh, come on. Be a human.
Yes, sir.
Punishment whiskey.
Oh, come on. Be a grown-ass person.
That's your punishment.
That's several call-outs now.
It tastes like chocolate.
Yeah, exactly.
It tastes like German chocolate cake. Yeah.
Here you go, buddy.
Dirty little freak.
What? No.
You got it. You got it. That maple. There you go. I'll
take my own swig from the bottle. There you go. I'm not a
Quit stalling, you bitch.
No, fuck you.
He's stalling like shit.
Oh, I'm stalling. Why don't you hit it?
I will.
No, watch out.
We both offered to take his maple whiskey.
I like how we're all getting punished because you're a fucking idiot.
That's because I called you out on it.
Oh, maple. Lordy, so lordy. Sweet. Look who's...
fucking apple.
Look who's 40.
Jim Beam.
Oh, Jim, I hate you.
You love Jim, don't lie.
I do, but not like...
So, like, did anybody see the Chronicles of Riddick?
I did, yes.
So, that's supposed to be, like, the sequel to fucking Pitch Black. Pitch Black, by the way, was a pretty dope movie because it introduced so many, like, it was a true sci-fi movie.
Yes.
That had a pretty good start to it and everything like that. Like I like the movie Pitch Black, but everything else Vin Diesel that has ever existed, with the exception of the Iron Giant, is trash.
Oh my god, that's right. He was in the Iron Giant.
He was the robot.
High five for your drunkenness.
Hold on. Not everything he's done is trash.
Name something that wasn't trash.
I am Groot.
Dude. Oh, fair enough. Fair enough.
Are you talking about the movie that was one with the power of friendship?
I am Groot.
He's right.
Are you talking about the movie that was one with the power of fucking friendship?
He's right. It was one with the power
of friendship. Are you talking about live action anime over here?
No, we're talking about Guardians of the Galaxy.
Who's that?
I don't know.
Yeah, who is that?
Her eyebrow game is serious.
Yeah. Lindsay?
She's kind of weird. Alright,
anyway. Okay. Alright. I'll see you.
I'll see you over here, pimp.
Super pimp. You can connect to the Wi-Fi, by the way. It's got the same password as before.
She over here pimping it up, y'all.
So, like, let's talk about some of these movies that are coming out, though.
Okay.
So, Star Wars announced a totally canon movie, but that's outside of their new trilogy.
Totally canon.
It's totally canon.
Yeah, I know it's totally canon.
Rogue One.
I thought they were going away from canon.
Nah. Now, all new Disney is canon.
I want you to say that one more time.
What did you
all
say?
New Disney is canon. Canon.
That just made me way more excited for episode 8, and I cannot fucking wait.
No, as in that the history that they create is canon.
Yeah, because it's like white history books where they're like, anything we say is true.
No.
There was never any racism.
There was no
slavery never existed for real.
Never.
Everything
any.
Is USA. When you write your own books.
Stupid.
Dude, that's exactly what I just...
War of 1812. Written off the book, Sancho Panza, Don Quixote Memory. I'm sorry, I'm done with my song.
All right, so Rogue One, when it got announced, I thought it was going to be about Rogue Squadron.
So, no, it's not about Rogue Squadron. It's about the people... You remember in that in episode 1 when they say a lot of people died to get us this plans for the Death Star?
Yes.
This is that movie.
Okay.
And, was it, like, Jane Erso or something like that?
Yes. Yeah, Erso. Jane Erso.
Like, this movie's probably going to be pretty dope because it's got It Man, mm-hmm. right? Like the movie's probably going to be pretty dope.
Oh, it's got Forrest Whitaker in it.
It looks pretty legit, man. Like, I'm actually kind of excited for this movie. Like, I didn't like episode 1. Like, I liked it. But I didn't
love
it.
Episode 1 was like pretty. Anything episode 1 through 3 was garbage.
Well, here's the thing. Yes.
You're talking about. Yes. So we're talking about. Are you talking about episode 4 or are you talking about episode 1?
Episode 1.
Okay,
yeah,
you're talking
episode
about episode
1.
Yeah, actually, yeah, I like Revenge of the Sith.
I do like Revenge of the Sith.
That was like one of the highest grossing movies, and I was
That's
like,
"That's because
what?
I'm gonna Sith say was I'm gonna say some fucked up shit right
because
now." When
Natalie
I say I didn't
Portman's
like New Hope,
super hot. What?
Okay, so that's what you mean. You do not like New Hope.
I didn't like New Hope. I loved Empire Strikes Back.
Yes.
I enjoyed the Revenge or Return of the Jedi.
Yeah.
But like these, like with the eighth or the seventh installment of these movies. Rehash of New Hope.
It was.
It might be why I don't like it as much.
Rehash. It was a rehash.
It might be why I don't like it as much. So like when I say, sorry, stop hitting myself.
Sorry.
So when I say I don't necessarily enjoy the whole Kylo Ren shit, but I'm excited for the Knights of Ren. Like I'm excited for that.
To see that.
Rey because she's a wonderful human. That's our
and it's wonderful.
But if I actually say that I'm excited for I didn't like New Hope, but I liked Empire Strikes Back. Right, like I'm excited for the second installment of that series because I think it might be like totally different and cool. Like I think I might get to see like the Knights of Ren and you get more Luke Skywalker training with Rey and stuff like that. Like I think it'll be cool.
I can't wait to see that so much.
Like
my whole thing is like, okay, so I know we're going away from this movie, but in Episode 8, people are asking, is she going to go with a traditional lightsaber? Or is she going to go with the dual lightsaber?
I think she's going to use fucking Luke's old lightsaber.
And you think she's going to use her old one, or is she going to go with the staff and make her own? I think she's going to use
Luke's old.
Ooh, yeah, but she's solid.
But if Luke trains her in the ways of old Jedi, then she's going to make her own lightsaber. Is it going to be a staff?
I don't think it'll be a staff. I think it'll be a traditional lightsaber for the Jedi Order.
She's so wonderful, and Daisy Ridley could literally do anything, anytime. And I think
to a previous episode. Nude on television.
You talking about mosquito titties?
Daisy Ridley?
She wasn't nude on TV.
By the way, not mosquito titties. You need to go look up that nude scene. She's dead, though.
Sorry, she was dead.
Dead. I've seen that. And she's wonderful, and she's beautiful, and she can do anything. Yes. She could literally be like,
Yas,
Daisy. Yeah, no, she's great. I heard, though, that she got rid of her Instagram because people were like, and they were like, being shitty. Which makes me mad because she's wonderful and that robs us all of the joy of seeing Daisy Ridley. Also, I'm very drunk, but you know, that's how we get on the show. Quincy, drink more, please.
You need to drink less.
So, I would like to make the formal announcement that I started out the show like 6 beers deep. And I'm still the most sober person on the show.
Because it's spread out over time.
I might have a problem.
Yeah, that, but also it's
I think the problem is...
that I'm not drinking enough?
Yeah, it's just sitting there, bro.
Yeah, it's come just on.
Alright, let's do it.
Yeah, I mean...
there you go.
A dirty little freak, huh?
That chocolate coconut, that's literally the taste that we all... like, I had that taste playing Grand
Theft
Auto.
That's the America with the watermelon vodka shot in it.
Ew, ooh. That's what you had?
Yeah.
Lordy, lordy. No.
So, Quincy. Do you know that Conor McGregor, Eddie Alvarez was announced for the title?
No, I did not know
155. So Dana wants Conor to relegate his title down at 145 to fight for this title. Conor says, no, I'm going to fight for both.
Hey-o!
So he's going to fight for the 155, and then he's going to go fight Aldo for the legitimacy of the 145.
So, for me, I think he'll beat Eddie Alvarez.
He will beat Eddie Alvarez, but I think in a second fight with Aldo, he will not beat him.
I think that Aldo only lost that fight because of rigging. Because Aldo...
are you calling it?
I'm calling that shit
out. Are you calling it?
Like are you, I are have you saying, never seen Jose Aldo get punked out
that's
like
what
bitch.
I'm saying. That's what I'm saying. Are you saying that Jose Aldo threw that fight?
Threw a fight for the UFC for fucking $4 million, probably.
Are you saying that?
Yes. Where have you seen? Have you seen Jose Aldo making a comeback tour?
No.
Have you seen him talking shit?
No.
Right. In what world do you believe a former gang member in the Brazilian underworld would not come back and try to go get his money back if he wasn't paid a substantial amount of money? There's no way I see Jose Aldo getting ducked out by a one punch knockout.
This is what I'm talking about, man. I've seen Jose Aldo kick a motherfucker in the leg so goddamn much he almost broke that shit. I don't see him getting knocked the fuck out by Conor McGregor like once, that. But I saw it. I saw it. So it was.
But that was so uncharacteristic.
Was it lucky? It was uncharacteristic. That's not Jose Aldo.
We're talking about a guy who's been a Muay Thai master for how long, and he let his guard down like that for a fucking sucker punch.
Exactly.
Not a sucker punch. An overhand right. I just don't see that. Not that guy. Not that dude. Like, I've seen that dude in some wars where he just brutalized people, and I don't see that fight being that way. Let's be fair.
Conor McGregor versus Nate Diaz exposed that dude as the fucking quintessential fighter.
Like the Jose Aldo fight with Conor McGregor is what I pictured The Conor McGregor Nate Diaz fight is what I pictured the Nate Diaz was what I pictured the Jose Aldo.
Okay, let's take a break. That's all. Continue.
Okay. The Nate Diaz Conor McGregor fight is what I pictured the Jose Aldo McGregor fight to be. That's what I pictured that fight to be.
The first fight. The way that guy used to fight, I just don't see that fight going down that way. Like, even if it did, even if it was legit, I still call shenanigans. Like, why wouldn't you just go out and fight that fight like the way that you fight it? Like for me, I see Conor can beat Eddie Alvarez. Like, I think that's
what I see that happening.
And at his own weight class, I don't see him getting gassed out, though, carrying that extra weight. You know, but that Jose Aldo fight is not legit. Like, that guy, I don't believe that. Like, Jose Aldo, to me, when he came over from Strikeforce, was one of the fucking just meanest, baddest-ass dudes I've ever seen. And I just don't... The only fight I really want to see is I want to see a healthy Jose Aldo with no leg injuries actually going out and fighting and winning fights against those guys who are, like, legit. Like on those levels. For me... there's a completely different kind of guy who's doing the Jose Aldo fight. I just don't see that thing actually happening. We can take a break for a second.
You gotta piss.
Oh shit! Not paused.
You're not.
So coincidentally, did you know that there's gonna be a Dan Henderson, as in my man Hendo, versus Michael Bisping for the title?
No, I didn't know that. I didn't know that.
Do you remember the first instance that happened between them?
No, I don't.
So my man's Michael Bisping got his ass knocked out by Dan Henderson with that right hook, and then my man, because it was supposed to be like Britain versus like the fucking USA, like my man's got his ass knocked out from fucking orbit.
That's Hendo, man. You know, Hendo, that's hands of stone. You know
what I mean? Hendo dropped his fist on him, right? It was so fucking gnarly. It was so fucking baller. It was so fucking badass that. As soon as he hit the ground, Hendo knew he was knocked out. He went ahead and dropped the fucking hammer on him anyway. Whoa. And from fucking orbit, like Sputnik orbit, dropped this fucking haymaker hand fist on his face. Like, it was just so fucking nasty.
Hendo, man. That dude has knocked so many people out until that time he got embarrassed by,
Dude. Spider
Silva.
He was already 40.
Yeah, he was. He was old.
My man's knocked out Vanderlei.
Yes.
My man's was the light heavyweight and fucking overall champion, like Grand Prix champion of the fucking Pride FC. Like, that dude is fucking baller. I want to see him at 43 years old knock out my dude Bisping, even though I like Bisping as a champion.
Oh, Bisping earned that. He earned that.
You know what, man? I was actually thinking that he would never have a chance in hell beat out, was it Luke Rockhold?
Yeah, Luke Rockhold.
But, like, remember, we were watching that fight together, actually.
Yeah, we were.
Like, I was like, this shit is destiny. Yes. And, like, fucking sure shit did he knock him out.
He did.
So, like,
I didn't see that coming at all.
I'm a Bisping guy. Like, I'll take me some Bisping. I like that he never stops trying. And I like that his...
Well, he'll fight anyone.
His kids are, like, 30. And he's like 20, he's like 27.
That's actually pretty bad.
She's a vampire.
He's Dracula. It's Dracula. He's Dracula.
This is a Dracula.
He's definitely a Dracula.
So I don't know if we've ever explained it before, but there's a difference between a Dracula and a Dracula.
And a Dracula.
So like a Dracula is Dracula. That's the fucking the Vlad the Impaler. Impala?
Impaler. The Impala. Vlad the Impala. He's a car.
Vlad the African goat.
Yeah, right. True.
Vlad the Impaler. Impaler. Right? But a Dracula is a person who doesn't age and is clearly a vampire, but we don't call them vampires. You don't say the V word. Don't say the V word.
No, not at all.
It's Dracula.
That would offend me.
That's a Dracula.
No, I don't. I'm not a V word, so we're good.
You know why this movie sucks? The hot chick lived.
Because of Children of the Corn 2.
Children of the Corn 2.
Right? So, like, what do you think about Bisping Henderson? How do you think it goes?
How do I think it goes? I say it goes all five.
I don't.
You don't think it goes all five?
I think fucking Bisping murders.
You think Bisping
unfortunately murders my man Hendo.
I think Hendo puts up a fight and he goes five.
Think about some of the greatest fights you've ever seen.
Okay.
Right? Hendo Vanderlei Silva.
Okay.
Hendo Shogun.
That was an epic fight.
Hendo Fedor Emelianenko.
Ooh. That was a good one, too.
At 43 years old, do you think he can still hang?
His last fight wasn't so bad.
I agree. And if this is the way he retires, I like him to go out on a shield.
That's what I'm saying. That's
the shield of the title and just retire.
That's what I'm saying. I mean, like, I don't think Hendo knocks him out. I don't think Bigsby knocks him out. I think he goes all five. And it's a war. I think it's a war. I think it's a war for five rounds.
I don't know if he can go five rounds.
You don't think he'll go five?
Nah.
Okay. I'll take that. It is what it is.
Do you know who Gegard Mousasi is?
No.
So Gegard Mousasi is the Iranian-born fighter who was trained under Fedor Emelianenko.
Okay.
On the same card, he's going to fight Vitor Belfort.
Ooh, that's enticing.
This might be fight of the night.
You think so? Okay, I've never seen that dude fight, but I have seen Vitor Belfort fight, and it could be a war. Could be a war.
Could be. You never know. So, Quincy.
Nope.
How's it feel to have a grenade in your pocket?
How does it feel? Oh my god.
I'll say this.
Here we go.
Hold on a second. So I'll throw a flashback. In the last episode, we talked about the Note 7, right? And that I was thinking about it. I was on the fence. I wasn't going to get it, but I had an upgrade. I have an upgrade available. I was thinking about it. Just to get it. Just to play with it. Just to hang out, right?
Who are you, me?
And then, yes. Yes, you do have a very bad electronics addiction. And we're in rehab. It's okay. It's okay. We're in rehab.
Please help me.
Right? Samsung creates a worldwide recall that our nondescript electronics company is calling a withdrawal.
The nondescript electronics company and Samsung are telling us to call it a withdrawal, not a recall.
Yeah. Literally,
but that shit is a recall.
The shit's a recall, is what it is.
Because the fucking battery blows up 10 minutes after it's off the charger.
Now, with that being said, the cases that they've had have not been in the USA. Now, me owning one, I haven't had an issue.
Let's be realistic about this, though. If one dude has a bad day at the factory and sods just a little bit extra on that battery, then we have an issue. Then the battery might explode. But there's been 35 of what, like 100,000 phones? 200, yeah, 300?
It's like 2.1 million or something like that. That's sold.
So we're talking about a very low. Let's do that math real quick. If you say 2.1 million, right?
2.1 million or something like that.
Those are the ones that sold, right? So, what percentage have had the battery explode?
35 is the exact number so far.
35 phones, not 35%. So, okay. No,
35 phones.
Okay, that's not so bad. I feel better holding this phone in my hand right now.
Well, feel better because it's not going to explode on you, and I've charged it.
That's what she said. That's what he said.
Every night since I've had it. So, I mean, it hasn't melted. It hasn't done anything.
You're brave.
It hasn't. It hasn't boot loops.
That's actually better than the Apple laptop I pulled out of my backpack earlier. That was like hot as
fuck. We're talking about it's less than.
I will say this. When it's charging,
give you a correct ratio. It's less than 0.00002% of the phones have had an issue.
I mean, that's right.
So why cause worldwide panic over 35 phones?
Because it blows up. And lights fire.
It lights fire.
When you say blows up and lights fire,
it actually starts heating so bad that it melts and catches fire. It doesn't exactly.
So, okay, that's what I would like. I'm not gonna lie. Bro. I would like to.
Do
see.
Do you know what happens when a fucking battery explodes inside of a laptop? Melts down, it explodes, and creates a fire. So the battery legit explodes.
Okay.
Right. So. The diodes inside the battery die and explode,
right? Mm-hmm. So it's a real issue, but it's only a fucking, what is it, 200,000ths of a phone, of the phones actually have that issue. They're creating a worldwide recall. So, the phone is still...
Sorry, the phone is still okay.
Let me see this phone.
Hi, I'm explosive.
It's pretty legit. I'm going to pull out the stylus real quick.
Boom. That's pretty legit. I mean, I haven't had an issue with it. I mean, I'm still going to turn mine in just because,
fuck. Yeah, why wouldn't
me,
you?
They're going to give me a new one. They're going to give me a new one. Fuck it. You know what I mean?
But the widespread panic that occurred with recalling that phone is huge, though. Like, Samsung's going to take a major hit in the market. They're going to replace every single S, every single S7 Edge.
Did you hear what happened to their stock?
Plummeted.
It plummeted.
Of course.
It plummeted.
So we're talking about that company just hit a major market.
So,
I mean, the this amount is of fascinating.
Do you know why Samsung's going to be okay, though? When's the last time you've been to the garbage. Hospital?
It's been a while.
When's the last time you got an X-ray?
Been a while.
Did you ever look at the machine?
Is it a Samsung machine?
Yes.
I didn't know that.
So, appliances inside your house. They can be Samsung.
Yes. TVs. TVs, they're selling TVs.
Quantum dot displays.
Yes.
So one of my favorite things of training new mobile people is I think they're going to go make their money off of going off and selling a TV. And one of my favorite things to do is like, do you know what quantum dot display is? Do you know what OLED means? Organic light emitting diodes? You know, do you understand those technologies? Like,
I know.
Do you
understand
DVR?
Do you know HDR, high dynamic range? Dolby 10.
Do you understand Dolby 10?
I sold a Dolby 10 today. Our fucking LG. Our Sony rep, our all our guys called out in the morning in home theater, so I actually walked back there and just sold fucking $5,000 in televisions.
What company do you work for? I'm just kidding. Fuck that.
But I mean, that's a separate breed. I mean, like, if you have that selling mentality, then you can just about sell anything. You know
but I mean? Actually, I like the home theater aspect. Like, I like researching those things because my whole thing to buying a TV is what appeals to your eye the most.
Exactly. Dolby 10 is definitely different than DVR.
I sold a $1,300 Sony TV. I sold an OLED 4K HDR TV, like fucking. It's all about what your eye sees. So like, let's get into this dichotomy because I actually like this home theater dichotomy real quick.
Let's do it.
So like, for me, my eye draws the clarity and the contrast that comes with a Sony or a Samsung television.
Okay.
Right. Like, so they have the quantum dot display, which puts out more color than any other TV. Right.
This is true.
But like, maybe that doesn't appeal to your eye as much.
Doesn't.
So you have the OLED factor inside of the LG TVs.
That's what my eye appeals to. I like the whole OLED. The thing about an OLED that a lot of people don't think about, OLED is basically the new plasma. Their blacks are blacker and their colors are way more.
But there's a trick
to
it. Yeah, so there is like a trick. Every single individual pigment inside the TV can turn on and off. So when you get those classic TVs that have those the backlighting, when you have those true blacks, the only true black you're going to get is on an LG TV, right? So for me, I sat next to an OLED television for too long inside a mobile, right? And I got to trick my eyes to seeing when I look at the OLED, I look at the black and then I look at the color and it's not as dynamic.
Mm. I believe that.
You think
especially
so?
No. It's so this is the thing with OLED. It's like the I am very drunk at this point, but here is the deal. Oh no. I can't. Oh my god, you guys, I'm way too drunk for this. Hey-o.
So, let's call it. let's call the podcast. This has been the fourth episode of the Fat and Tunnel Bastards.
I'm so sorry.
We got our engineer back. Caitlin didn't make it. We got our engineer back. She didn't make it, but she fixed the mic, so it's a lot better.
I love you guys. I'm very drunk. I love you guys. Oh my god. Oh my god.